Insta Current Affairs Quiz. May 2023. www.insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightsonindia.com/insightson 3. Geography, 14. 4. Government schemes and programs, 19. 5. Science and technology, 27. 6. International relations and organizations, 33. 7. Polity, 38. 8. History, art and culture, 48. 9. States, 52. 10. Agriculture, 52. 11. Defense and security, 55. 12. Reports and indices, 56. 13. Maps, places, 58. 14. Miscellaneous, 61. 1. 1. Economy. 1. Consider the following statements regarding applications supported by Block Amount ASBA, like facility for trading. 1. ASBA is an application by an investor that contains an authorization to a self-certified syndicate bank, SCSB, to block in the bank account the application money for subscribing to an issue. 2. The facility will be optional for investors and stockbrokers. 3. Recently SEBI cancelled the application supported by Block Amount ASBA, like facility for trading in the secondary market. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1 only. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution A. The Capital Markets Regulator, Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, recently approved a framework for application supported by Block Amount ASBA, like facility for trading in the secondary market. The facility will be optional for investors and stockbrokers. To facilitate smooth transition in the market, the framework will be implemented in a phased manner. ASBA, which was first introduced by SEBI in 2008, is an application by an investor that contains an authorization to a self-certified syndicate bank, SCSB, to block in the bank account the application money for subscribing to an issue. An SCSB is a recognized bank capable of providing ASBA services to its customers. The application money of an investor applying through ASBA shall be debited from the bank account only if her application is selected for allotment after the basis of allotment has been finalized. In public issues and rights issues, all investors have to mandatorily apply through ASBA. At present, ASBA is available for the primary market, wherein the initial public offering IPO funds only are blocked on application and are debited only on allotment. Source. 2. Which of the following are recognized as Three Sisters by the World Trade Organization's WTO Sanitary and Phytosanitary Measures SPS Agreement? 1. Codex Alimentarius Commission. 2. International Plant Protection Convention IPPC. 3. Pacific Plant Protection Organization. 4. World Organization for Animal Health. Select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2, 3. B. 1, 2, 4. C. 2, 3, 4. D. 2, 4. Solution B. The International Plant Protection Convention IPPC is one of the Three Sisters recognized by the World Trade Organization's WTO Sanitary and Phytosanitary Measures SPS Agreement along with the Codex Alimentarius. 2. Commission for Food Safety Standards and the World Organization for Animal Health for Animal Health Standards. 3. The Financial Stability Report by RBI looks at which of the following aspects. 1. Do Indian banks, both public and private, have enough capital to run their operations? 2. Are the levels of bad loans or non-performing assets within manageable limits? 3. Are different sectors of the economy able to get credit for economic activity? Select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution D. The FSR looks at questions like do Indian banks, both public and private, have enough capital to run their operations? Are the levels of bad loans or non-performing assets within manageable limits? Are different sectors of the economy able to get credit for new loans for economic activities such as starting a new business or buying a new house or car? 4. Consider the following statements regarding standing deposit facility SDF. 1. It has been introduced by Reserve Bank of India. 2. Like marginal standing facility MSF, the SDF will be available on all days of the week throughout the year. 3. It aims to induce liquidity in the system to promote growth. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution A. In 2018, the amended Section 17 of the RBI Act empowered the Reserve Bank to introduce the SDF and additional tool for absorbing liquidity without any collateral. By removing the binding collateral constraint from the RBI, the SDF strengthens the operating framework of monetary policy. The SDF is also a financial stability tool in addition to its role in liquidity management. The main purpose of SDF is to reduce the excess liquidity in the system and control inflation. Both the standing facilities, the MSF marginal standing facility, and the SDF will be available on all days of the week throughout the year. 5. Consider the following statements. 1. As per the present rules, global investors are not allowed to participate in initial public offering IPO of a company owned by the government. 2. A red herring prospectus is a document filed by a company to SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, when it plans to raise money through initial public offering IPO. Which of the above statements is incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution A. 3. Global investors are allowed to participate in initial public offering IPO of a company owned by the government. A red herring prospectus or offer document is filed by a company to SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, when it plans to raise money from the public by selling shares of the company to investors. The document is very useful to investors because it provides detailed information about the company's business operations, financials, promoters, and the company's objective for raising funds by filing in IPOs. 6. The funds allocated by the International Development Association IDA to countries depends on 1. Country's income level. 2. Performance record in managing their economies and ongoing IDA projects. 3. Lack of creditworthiness to borrow on market terms. Select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution D. IDA borrowers have significant needs for concessional funds. IDA must therefore make decisions about how to allocate scarce resources among eligible countries. Allocation decisions are based on several criteria, including each country's income level and performance record in managing their economies and ongoing IDA projects. To be eligible for funds, countries must first meet the following criteria. Relative poverty defined as GNI per capita must be below an established threshold updated annually. In fiscal year 2023, this was $1,255. Lack creditworthiness to borrow on market terms and therefore have need for concessional resources to finance the country's development program. In addition, countries are then assessed to determine how well they implement policies that promote economic growth and poverty reduction. 7. Consider the following statements regarding exchange-traded funds, ETF. 1. ETFs are passive funds listed and traded on stock exchanges like shares. 2. In an ETF, one can buy and sell units at prevailing market price on a real-time basis during market hours. 3. Usually the fund manager selects stocks based on customer's choice. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 3. B. 2. Only. C. 1. 2. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution C. Exchange-traded funds, ETFs. Typically, an ETF mirrors a particular index, which means the group of stocks in the ETF would be similar to those in the index that it is benchmarked to. They are traded on stock exchanges like shares. Usually, ETFs are passive funds where the fund manager doesn't select stocks on your behalf. Instead, the ETF simply copies an index and endeavors to accurately reflect its performance. In an ETF, one can buy and sell units at prevailing market price on a real-time basis during market hours. A. Consider the following statements. 4. 1. Import cover is the number of months of imports that could be paid for by a country's forex reserves. 2. The policy of import substitution aims to change the economic structure of the country by replacing foreign goods with domestic goods. 3. RBI has declared that minimum 2 years of import cover is essential for the stability of rupee. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 2. 3. C. 1. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution A. Import substitution is a strategy under trade policy that abolishes the import of foreign products encourages for the production in the domestic market. The purpose of this policy is to change the economic structure of the country by replacing foreign goods with domestic goods. Post-independence, India adopted the policy of import substitution by imposing heavy tariffs on import duty. Import cover measures the number of months of imports that can be covered with foreign exchange reserves available with the central bank of the country. 8 to 10 months of import cover is essential for the stability of the currency. 9. Consider the following statements regarding Foreign Exchange Management Act. 1. Foreign Exchange Management Act came as a successor to the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act, with changing economic conditions in a post-liberalization India. 2. This act makes offenses related to foreign exchange as criminal offenses. 3. Enforcement Directorate has the power to register a case against an organization under the Foreign Exchange Management Act, FEMA, for alleged foreign exchange violation. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1, 2. C. 1, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. The Enforcement Directorate had registered a case against the British Broadcasting Corporation, BBC India, under the Foreign Exchange Management Act, FEMA, for alleged foreign exchange violation. What is the aim of the FEMA Foreign Exchange Management Act? FEMA came in 1999 as a successor to the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act of FERA of 1973, with changing economic conditions in a post-liberalization India. So what changed with the FEMA? Reflecting the major change in mindset was the decision to make offenses or violations under the slower civil offense rather than criminal one, and making transactions that are part of the current account, such as traveling abroad for tourism, education, etc., a matter of right while putting in place restrictions on the capital account. Source. 10. In an economy, the term for establishments having formal existence but with close to no operations or assets is called as. A. Sick industry. B. Benami property. C. Ghost company. D. Tax haven. 5. Solution C. A shell corporation, ghost company is a corporation without active business operations or significant assets. These types of corporations are sometimes used illegitimately, such as to disguise business ownership from law enforcement or the public. Shell corporations act as tax avoidance vehicles for legitimate businesses. 11. Consider the following statements regarding company limited by guarantee. 1. A company limited by guarantee is one in which, if the company goes bankrupt, those running it only have to pay a sum they have guaranteed to pay when it was set up. 2. Such a company has no shareholders, but is owned by a group of people called members or guarantors. 3. Usually, this structure is put in place for charitable organizations and non-profits. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution D. What is a company limited by guarantee? A company limited by guarantee is one in which, if the company goes bankrupt, those running it only have to pay a sum they have guaranteed to pay when it was set up. The Companies Act 2013 says, company limited by guarantee means a company having the liability of its members limited by the memorandum to such amount as the members may respectively undertake to contribute to the assets of the company in the event of its being wound up. Put very simply, such a company has no shareholders, but is owned by a group of people called members or guarantors. When coming together to form the company, these members pledge to pay a certain amount, usually not a large amount, in case it is wound up. Their liability, if the company fails, is limited to this amount. Usually, this structure is put in place for charitable organizations and non-profits, where any profit earned by the company is reinvested into the business. The members or guarantors can seek donations and funds in the name of the company, but if it fails, they are shielded from the debts it may have accrued. Source. 12. Consider the following statements regarding Goods and Services Tax Council. 1. Every decision of the Goods and Services Tax Council shall be taken by a majority of not less than 3/4 of the weighted votes of the members present in voting. 2. The vote of the central government in the GST Council meeting shall have a weight of 2/3 of the total votes cast. Which of the above statements is incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution B. Every decision of the Goods and Services Tax Council shall be taken at a meeting by a majority of not less than 3/4 of the weighted votes of the members present in voting, in accordance with the following principles, namely, the vote of the central government shall have a weighted of 1/3 of the total votes cast, and 6. The votes of all the state governments taken together shall have a weighted of 2/3 of the total votes cast in the meeting. 13. Consider the following statements regarding base year. 1. The base year is a representative year which must not experience any abnormal incidents such as droughts, floods, earthquakes, etc. 2. It gives an idea about changes in purchasing power and allows calculation of inflation adjusted growth estimates. Which of the above statements is incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution D. The base year of the national accounts is chosen to enable inter-year comparisons. It gives an idea about changes in purchasing power and allows calculation of inflation adjusted growth estimates. The base year prices are termed as constant prices. This reduces all the data to a comparable benchmark, base year price. The base year is a representative year which must not experience any abnormal incidents such as droughts, floods, earthquakes, etc. 14. Consider the following statements regarding invoicing with respect to GST. 1. The primary objective of invoicing is to enable interoperability across the entire GST ecosystem. 2. It will help to curb the actions of tax evaders and reduce the number of frauds. 3. At present it is implemented only for large companies with turnover of over 500 crore rupees. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1, 2. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution B. The government has also lowered the threshold for businesses to generate A. Invoice for business to business, B2B, transactions to 5 crore rupees from 10 crore rupees under GST. A. Invoicing was initially implemented for large companies with turnover of over 500 crore rupees, and within 3 years the threshold has now been lowered to 5 crore rupees. What does the A. Invoicing envisage? The GST Council in its 37th meeting in September 2019 had approved the standard of A. Invoice with the primary objective to enable interoperability across the entire GST ecosystem. Under this, a phased implementation was proposed to ensure a common standard for all invoices, that is, an invoice generated by one software should be capable of being read by any other software and through machine readability, an invoice can then be uniformly interpreted. With a uniform invoicing system, the tax authorities are able to pre-populate the return and reduce the reconciliation issues. With a high number of cases involving fake invoices and fraud availment of input tax credit, GST authorities have pushed for implementation of the invoicing system which is expected to help to curb the actions of tax evaders and reduce the number of frauds that the tax authorities will have access to data in real time. Source. 15. Which of the following situations can lead to inflation? 7. A reduction in the money supply. B. Higher levels of unemployment. C. Sluggish growth of aggregate demand. D. Rapid growth of aggregate demand outweighing supply. Solution D. Demand pull inflation is a period of inflation which arises from rapid growth in aggregate demand. It occurs when economic growth is too fast. If aggregate demand rises faster than productive capacity, LRS, then firms will respond by putting up prices, creating inflation. 16. Which of the following is a measure that can be used by the government to combat inflation? A. Reduction in the cash reserve ratio, CRR. B. Providing more subsidies on exports. C. Increasing the rate of interest on savings and fixed deposits. D. Increasing the non-planned expenditure on defense, police, etc. Solution C. Increasing the rate of interest on savings and fixed deposits attracts people to park their money in the banks, which in turn helps to reduce inflation. 17. Consider the following statements. 1. When RBI books profit by selling dollars, it pays dividend to the central government. 2. In the last 5 years, the RBI was a net seller of dollars in each financial year. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution A. In FY 2023, the Reserve Bank of India, RBI, became a net seller of the US dollar after remaining a net purchaser for 3 consecutive years. Source. 8. 2. Ecology and environment. 1. Consider the following statements regarding ocean acidification. 1. Ocean acidification is caused by uptake of carbon dioxide, CO, emitted by human activities. 2. It brings changes in species dominance, leading to ecosystem shifts in coastal waters. 3. Ocean acidification leads to increase in the pH of the ocean over an extended time. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution A. Ocean acidity or ocean acidification is a reduction in the pH of the ocean over an extended time. It is caused by uptake of carbon dioxide, CO, a greenhouse gas emitted by human activities. The ocean's average pH is now around 8.1, which is basic or alkaline. But as the ocean continues to absorb more carbon dioxide, the pH decreases and the ocean becomes more acidic. This has contributed to the loss of corals on a global scale as their calcium skeletons are weakened by more acidic water. This also erodes and affects the formation of shells of shellfish. It has thus brought changes in relative species dominance, potentially leading to ecosystem shifts in coastal waters. 2. Which of the following regions of India is the natural habitat of the Great Indian Hornbill? A. Sand deserts of northwest India. B. Great Himalayan Range. C. Salt marshes of western Gujarat. D. Western Ghats. Solution D. The Great Indian Hornbill is one of the larger members of the Hornbill family. It is found in the Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia. It is naturally found in Western Ghats. 3. Consider the following statements regarding National Green Tribunal, NGT. 1. The exercise of power by the National Green Tribunal is always circumscribed by the receipt of applications. 2. The tribunal performs vital roles that are preventative, ameliorative, or remedial in nature. 3. NGT deals with all environmental issues both as original and also as an appellate authority. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. The Supreme Court has declared the National Green Tribunal's NGT position as a unique forum endowed with sumo motu powers to take up environmental issues across the country. The exercise of power by the NGT is not circumscribed by the receipt of applications. When substantial questions relating to the environment arise and the issue is civil in nature and those related to the Act, the NGT, in our opinion, even in the absence of an application, can self-ignite action either towards amelioration or towards prevention of harm, a three-judge bench held in a judgment. 9. The tribunal has to perform equally vital roles that are preventative, ameliorative or remedial in nature. The functional capacity of the NGT was intended to leverage white powers to do full justice in its environmental mandate. The judgment described the NGT as a complementary, competent, specialized forum to deal with all environmental multidisciplinary issues both its original and also as an appellate authority, which complex issues were hitherto dealt with by the High Courts and the Supreme Court. Unlike the civil courts, which cannot travel beyond the relief sought by the parties, the NGT is conferred with power of moving any relief, the court stated. 4. Consider the following statements regarding UN Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC. 1. The UN Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC, is an international agreement that acknowledges the differentiated responsibility of nations. 2. According to the agreement, which countries shall provide both the finance and the technology to developing nations to help tackle climate change? 3. UNFCCC explicitly mentions for compensation for loss and damage from climate disasters. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. B. The UN Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC, the 1994 international agreement that lays down the broad principles of the global effort to fight climate change, acknowledges the differentiated responsibility of nations. It makes it clear that rich countries shall provide both the finance and the technology to developing nations to help tackle climate change. However, the UNFCCC does not mention loss and damage. In 2009, developed countries agreed to provide $100 billion every year from 2020 to help developing nations fight climate change. However, they're struggling to fulfill this promise. It was after much struggle that developing countries and environment groups managed to establish a separate channel on loss and damages. The Warsaw International Mechanism, WIM, for loss and damages, set up in 2013, was the first formal acknowledgement of the need to compensate developing countries struck by climate disasters. 5. Consider the following statements regarding Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services, IPBES. 1. The Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services, IPBES, is a United Nations body that strengthens the science policy interface for biodiversity and ecosystem services. 2. It is intended to serve a similar role to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. 3. United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP, provides secretariat services to IPBES. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. C. The Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services, IPBES, is an independent intergovernmental body established by states to strengthen the science policy interface for. 10. Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services for the conservation and sustainable use of biodiversity, long-term human well-being and sustainable development. It was established in Panama City on the 21st of April 2012 by 94 governments. It is not a United Nations body. However, at the request of the Peace Plenary and with the authorization of the UNEP Governing Council in 2013, the United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP, provides secretariat services to IPBES. It is intended to serve a similar role to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. Source. 6. Recently, India launched International Big Cat Alliance, IBCA, for conservation of big cats, which include 1. Leopard. 2. Cheetah. 3. Jaguar. 4. Snow leopard. 5. Lion. Select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2, 3, 4. B. 1, 2, 3, 5. C. 1, 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Solution. D. International Big Cats Alliance, IBCA, will focus on the protection and conservation of 7 major big cats of the world, including tiger, lion, leopard, snow leopard, puma, jaguar and cheetah, with membership of the range countries harboring these species. Project Tiger was launched by the central government on April 1, 1973, in a bid to promote conservation of the tiger. Launched at the Jim Corbett National Park, the program was initially started in 9 tiger reserves of different states such as Assam, Bihar, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Orissa, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal, covering over 14,000 square kilometers. Notably, Project Tiger didn't just focus on the conservation of the big cats. It also ensured the preservation of their natural habitat as tigers are at the top of the food chain. Source. 7. Consider the following statements regarding Mangalajudi area. 1. Mangalajudi is recognized as globally important for the conservation of bird population, where the area is used for roosting and nesting by migratory birds. 2. It is located at the edge of the Kolyu Lake in Andhra Pradesh. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. A. Mangalajudi area is located on the banks of Chilika Lake, an important bird area. Eba. Mangalajudi is recognized as globally important for the conservation of bird population. The area is used for roosting and nesting by migratory birds. The area is 8.3 square km of marshy land with emergent vegetation. 11. A. Consider the following pairs. 1. Paramikulam Tiger Reserve, Kerala. 2. Mahananda Wildlife Sanctuary, West Bengal. 3. Mukundra Hills Tiger Reserve, Maharashtra. 4. Pilibhit Tiger Reserve, Rajasthan. 5. Gandhi Sagar Wildlife Sanctuary, Madhya Pradesh. Which of the above pairs is correctly matched? A. 1, 2, 3. B. 1, 2, 5. C. 2, 3, 4. D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Solution. B. Paramikulam Tiger Reserve is a protected area lying in Palakkad District and Thrissur District of Kerala. Mahananda Wildlife Sanctuary is located on the foothills of the Himalayas, between the Teesta and Mahananda Rivers. It is situated in the Darjeeling District of West Bengal. The Mukundra Tiger Reserve, TR, is located near Kota, Rajasthan. Pilibhit Tiger Reserve is located in Pilibhit District of Uttar Pradesh and was notified as a Tiger Reserve in 2014. Gandhi Sagar Sanctuary is a wildlife sanctuary situated on the northern boundary of Mandsaur and Nimaj districts in Madhya Pradesh. Source. 9. Which of the following best describes the term greenwashing? A. Making mandatory provisions for environmental costs in government programs. B. Ignoring the disastrous ecological consequences while undertaking infrastructure development. C. Making an unsubstantiated claim to deceive consumers into believing that the company's products are environmentally friendly. D. Non-inclusion of ecological environmental costs in the environmental impact assessment. Solution. C. There is a growing tendency among firms and governments to mark all kinds of activities as climate friendly as something that would lead to emissions reduction or avoidance of emissions. Many of these claims are unverifiable, misleading, or dubious. While they help in boosting the image of the entity, sometimes even helping them garner benefits, they do nothing in the fight against climate change. Greenwashing presents a false picture of the progress being made on the climate change front, thereby pushing the world towards disaster, while at the same time rewarding entities for irresponsible behavior. 10. Consider the following statements regarding icebergs. 1. An iceberg is a large piece of freshwater ice that has broken off a glacier or an ice shelf and is floating freely in open water. 2. The ocean currents influence the movement of icebergs. 3. Icebergs carry dust which fertilizes ocean plankton. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 3. B. 2. 3. C. 1. 2. D. 1. 2. 3. 12. Solution. D. An iceberg is a large piece of freshwater ice that has broken off a glacier or an ice shelf and is floating freely in open, salt water. Icebergs travel with ocean currents and either get caught up in shallow waters or drown themselves. On the other hand, there are some positives of an iceberg being stuck in the open ocean, since icebergs carry dust which fertilizes ocean plankton, which draws up carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. 11. The terms, absorptive capacity and carrying capacity, are used in the discourse of employment elasticity. B. Geographical determinism. C. Evolutionary biology. D. Sustainable development. Solution. D. The environment performs four vital functions. I. It supplies resources. Resources here include both renewable and non-renewable resources. E. It assimilates waste. E. It sustains life by providing genetic and biodiversity. And I. It also provides aesthetic services like scenery, etc. The environment is able to perform these functions without any interruption as long as the demand on these functions is within its carrying capacity. This implies that the resource extraction is not about the rate of regeneration of the resource and the waste generated are within the assimilating capacity of the environment. Absorptive capacity means the ability of the environment to absorb degradation. 12. Consider the following pairs. 1. Lokit Lake, Meghalaya. 2. Umin Lake, Manipur. 3. Kuleru Lake, Andhra Pradesh. 4. Pulikit Lake, Andhra Pradesh. Which of the above pairs is correct? A. 1. 2. 3. B. 1. 3. 4. C. 3. 4. D. 2. 3. 4. Solution. C. Lokit Lake is a freshwater lake in Manipur. It is the largest freshwater lake in South Asia. Umin Lake is a reservoir in the hills north of Shillong in the state of Meghalaya. Kuleru Lake is one of the largest freshwater lakes in India, located in the state of Andhra Pradesh, and forms the largest shallow freshwater lake in Asia. Pulikit Lake is the second largest brackish water lagoon in India after Chilika Lake. Major part of the lagoon comes under the Tirupati district of Andhra Pradesh. 13. 3. Geography. 1. Consider the following statements. 1. Mauna Loa is the largest active volcano in the world. 2. Mauna Loa is part of Hawaiian Archipelago. 3. Mount St. Helens is an active stratovolcano located in the United States. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2. 3. B. 1. 3. C. 1. 2. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. Mauna Loa is one of five volcanoes that together make up the Big Island of Hawaii, which is the southernmost island in the Hawaiian Archipelago. It's not the tallest, that title goes to Mauna Kea, but it's the largest and makes up about half of the island's landmass. It sits immediately north of Kilauea Volcano, which is currently erupting from its summit crater. Mauna Loa last erupted 38 years ago. Mount St. Helens is an active stratovolcano located in Somalia County, Washington, in the Pacific Northwest region of the United States. 2. Consider the following statements. 1. Hawaii's volcanoes and Japan's Mount Fuji are examples for shield volcanoes. 2. The gas in the magma of Hawaii's volcanoes tends to escape, and so lava flows down the side of their mountains when they erupt. 3. In composite volcanoes, the steep, conical slopes are built by the eruption of viscous lava flows and rock, ash and gas. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. C. The gas in the magma of Hawaii's volcanoes tends to escape, and so lava flows down the side of their mountains when they erupt. Hawaii's volcanoes are called shield volcanoes because successive lava flows over hundreds of thousands of years build broad mountains that resemble the shape of a warrior's shield. Shield volcanoes are also found in California and Idaho as well as Iceland and the Galapagos Islands. Alaska's Wrangell Strait. Alaska National Park has 8 shield volcanoes including Mount Wrangell. Volcanoes like Mount St. Helens are called composite or strait volcanoes. Their steep, conical slopes are built by the eruption of viscous lava flows and rock, ash and gas. Japan's Mount Fuji is another example of a composite volcano. How do scientists monitor Mauna Loa? Scientists use tiltmeters to track long-term changes in the tilting of the ground, helping them identify when the ground is swelling or deflating. A rapid change in tilt can indicate when an eruption will occur. There's also a thermal webcam at Mauna Loa summit that will identify the presence of heat. And satellite radar can keep track of ground swelling and deflation. 3. Ganymede, Callisto and Europa are the moons of Saturn. B. Mercury. C. Jupiter. 14. D. Venus Solution. C. What is the Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer JUICE mission? According to European Space Agency, ESA website, the JUICE will make detailed observations of the giant gas planet and its three large ocean-bearing moons, Ganymede, Callisto and Europa, by using remote sensing, geophysical and in-situ instruments. Scientists for quite some time have known that these three moons of Jupiter possess icy crust, which they believe contain oceans of liquid water underneath, making them potentially habitable. JUICE will help probe these water bodies by creating detailed maps of the moon surfaces and enable the scientists, for the first time, to look beneath them. Source. 4. Consider the following statements regarding Zero Shadow Day. 1. During Zero Shadow Day, the vertical objects appear to cast no shadow. 2. Every point on Earth experiences zero shadow day on different days in a year. 3. One zero shadow day falls during the uterine when the sun moves northwards, and the other during the shine when the sun moves southwards. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1. 2. C. 1. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. C. At 12:17 p.m. on April 25th, Bengaluru experienced a zero shadow day when vertical objects appeared to cast no shadow. This was because the sun was at its zenith, and so the shadow was directly under the object. For every point on Earth between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, there are 2 zero shadow days a year. The zero shadow day is restricted to locations between the tropics, and so places north of Ranchi in India are out of it. One falls during the uterine when the sun moves northwards, and the other is during the dakshinayan when the sun moves southwards. Uterine, movement of the sun from south to north from winter solstice to summer solstice, and dakshinayan back from north to south, happen because Earth's rotation axis is tilted at an angle of roughly 23.5 degrees to the axis of revolution around the sun. Source. 5. The typical impacts of El Niño include. 1. Severe droughts in parts of southern South America, the Horn of Africa and Central Asia. 2. Increased rainfall over Australia, Indonesia, and parts of southern Asia. 3. Hurricanes in the central, eastern Pacific Ocean and Canadian hurricane formation in the Atlantic. Basin. Select the correct answer code. A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 3 only. 15. D. 2. 3. Solution. C. The typical impacts of El Niño include increased rainfall in parts of southern South America, the southern United States, the Horn of Africa and Central Asia. It can also cause severe droughts over Australia, Indonesia, and parts of southern Asia. During summer in the northern hemisphere, El Niño's warm water can fuel hurricanes in the central, eastern Pacific Ocean and Canadian hurricane formation in the Atlantic Basin. El Niño might bring respite from the drought in the Horn of Africa and other El Niño-related impacts, but could also trigger more extreme weather and climate events. Source. 6. Consider the following statements. 1. When compared to Earth, the Moon is significantly depleted of volatile elements such as sodium. 2. Sodium is the only element that can be observed through telescopes in the lunar atmosphere. Which of the above statements are incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. B. When compared to Earth, the Moon is significantly depleted of volatile elements such as sodium. The amount of volatiles on the Moon today can be used to test formation scenarios of the Earth-Moon system. Sodium is the only element apart from potassium that can be observed through telescopes in the lunar atmosphere, its exosphere. 7. Consider the following statements. 1. An early or delayed onset of monsoon over Kerala has a direct impact on the monsoon performance over the rest of the season throughout the country. 2. In the last 10 years, the onset of monsoon over Kerala has not happened on a normal date. 3. El Niño has the effect of suppressing the Indian monsoon rainfall. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2. 3. B. 1. 3. C. 3 only. D. 1. 2. Solution. C. The onset of monsoon over the Kerala coast is just a marker of the official beginning of the 4-month monsoon season that brings more than 75% of India's annual rainfall. An early or delayed onset over Kerala does not in any way dictate monsoon performance over the rest of the season. In fact, the onset over the Kerala coast is not even the start of the monsoon rains over India. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands start getting the rains at least 2 weeks before Kerala does. Sometimes, even parts of Kerala get rains for a few days before the onset is officially announced. The onset is just a declaration that a set of criteria defined by the IMD to identify the arrival of the monsoon over the Indian mainland has been met. For this purpose, the IMD tracks rains at 14 selected meteorological stations on the Kerala coast. If at least 60% of these stations, that is at least 9 of them, get at least 2.5 mm 16. Rainfall for 2 consecutive days anytime after May 10th, the onset is said to have occurred. There are a few other accompanying criteria relating to wind speed and pressure, which need to be satisfied. The monsoon then moves northwards, the speed of its movement dictated by local atmospheric conditions and the development of low pressure areas. The normal arrival dates at different locations in the country are known, but the progression of monsoon does not always follow these dates. Late arrival over Kerala sometimes delays the arrival at some other locations as well, but not always. In the past 5 years, only once has the onset over Kerala happened on the normal date, in 2020. In the past 11 years, it has happened once more. On other occasions, the onset was either a few days earlier or later. But this has no correlation with the amount of rainfall during the monsoon season. In 2016, for example, the onset happened on June 8th, the most delayed in the past 12 years. The rainfall this year was normal, 97.5% of the long period average. Recent forecasts suggest that El Niño, the warming of the equatorial Pacific Ocean that impacts weather events worldwide, is likely to develop earlier than expected. El Niño has the effect of suppressing the Indian monsoon rainfall. Source. 8. According to Census 2011, which of the following statements is incorrect? 1. A person aged 7 and above, who can both read and write with understanding in any language, is treated as literate. 2. A person who can only read but cannot write, is not literate. Select the correct answer code. A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. D. For the purpose of Census 2011, a person aged 7 and above, who can both read and write with understanding in any language, is treated as literate. A person who can only read but cannot write, is not literate. In the census prior to 1991, children below 5 years of age were necessarily treated as literates. 9. The Tropic of Cancer passes through how many coastal and landlocked states in India, respectively? A. 2 and 5. B. 2 and 6. C. 3 and 5. D. 1 and 7. Solution. B. In India, the Tropic of Cancer passes through states of Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram. 10. Consider the following statements. 1. Melanesia, Micronesia, and Polynesia are the major groups of Pacific Islands. 2. Papua New Guinea is located north of Australia. 3. Papua New Guinea is among the least populous Pacific Island nation. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. 17. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. A. The Pacific Islands are a group of islands in the Pacific Ocean. They are further categorized into three major island groups: Melanesia, Micronesia, and Polynesia. Papua New Guinea's location just north of Australia makes it strategically significant. It was the site of fierce battles during World War II, and with a population of nearly 10 million people, it's one of the most populous Pacific island nations. Source. 11. Consider the following statements regarding cumulonimbus clouds. 1. They are born through convection. 2. They are large cauliflower-shaped towers, often angled tops. 3. It is the only cloud type that can produce hail, thunder, and lightning. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. Cumulonimbus is a dense, towering vertical cloud, typically forming from water vapor condensing in the lower troposphere that builds upward carried by powerful buoyant air currents. Above the lower portions of the cumulonimbus, the water vapor becomes ice crystals, such as snow and rubble, the interaction of which can lead to hail and lightning formation, respectively. Cumulonimbus storm cells can produce torrential rain of a convective nature. Stages of a cumulonimbus cloud's life. 12. Which two rivers flow in the region between Gulbarga and Vijayanagara Hampi? A. Kaveri and Periyar. B. Mahanadi and Godavari. C. Narmada and Godavari. D. Krishna and Tungabhadra. Solution. D. 18. 4. Government schemes and programs. 1. Tejaswini Rural Women Empowerment Program was implemented in Madhya Pradesh by World Bank. B. World Food Program, WFP. C. Food and Agricultural Organization, FAO. D. International Fund for Agricultural Development, IFAD. Solution. D. Tejaswini Rural Women Empowerment Program implemented by the UN-affiliated International Fund for Agricultural Development, IFAD, in Madhya Pradesh. Tejaswini program showed that growing millets meant a nearly 10 times increase in income from 1,800 rupees a month in 2013-14 to 16,277 rupees in 2020-21 with better food security. Women were key to villages adopting millets, as they were able to demonstrate that millets were easier to grow and led to better outcomes. 2. Consider the following statements. 1. RTI Portal Gateway to Citizens is an initiative taken by Department of Personnel and Training. 2. Under the RTI Law, information commissions are the final appellate authority and are mandated to safeguard and facilitate people's fundamental right to information. 3. The RTI Law mandated that one-third of the posts in the information commissions are to be occupied by women. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2 only. B. 1. 2. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 3. Solution. B. Right to Information Act 2005 mandates timely response to citizen requests for government information. It is an initiative taken by Department of Personnel and Training, Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions to provide ARTI portal gateway to the citizens for quick search of information on the details of first appellate authorities, PIOs, etc. Amongst others, besides access to RTI-related information, disclosures published on the web by various public authorities under the Government of India as well as the state governments. Under the RTI Law, information commissions are the final appellate authority and are mandated to safeguard and facilitate people's fundamental right to information. The report says 2 out of 29 information commissions across the country are completely defunct, 4 of them headless at the moment, and only 5% of the positions being occupied by women. 3. The National Food Security Act, NFSA, 2013 anchors which are the following. 1. Targeted Public Distribution System, TPDS. 2. PM Portion Scheme. 3. Integrated Child Development Services, ICDS. 4. PM Kisan Samman Nidhi, select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2, 4. B. 1, 3. C. 1, 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3, 4. 19. Solution. C. National Food Security Act, NFSA, 2013 anchors the Targeted Public Distribution System, TPDS, the PM Portion Scheme, earlier known as the Mid-Day Meal Scheme, and the Integrated Child Development Services, ICDS. 4. Match the following initiatives by the Government of India. 1. Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana focuses on more crops per drop. 2. Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, B. Promotes organic farming. 3. Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana, C. Maintenance of Soil Fertility. 4. Integrated Nutrient Management, D. Improving Food Access, especially for vulnerable populations. Select the correct answer code. 1, B, 2, 3, C, 4, laughing face, B, 1, 2, B, 3, laughing face, 4, C, C, 1, B, 2, 3, laughing face, 4, C, D, 1, 2, B, 3, C, 4, laughing face, solution, C. Some initiatives by the Government of India on better production include Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, which promotes organic farming, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, which focuses on more crops per drop for improved water use, and soil health management, which fosters integrated nutrient management. Under the National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. For improving food access, especially for vulnerable populations, the Government of India drives programs such as the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana, PMGKY, the Pradhan Mantri Poshan Shakti Nirman Yojana, PM Poshan Scheme, and take-home rations. 5. The Government uses Direct Benefit Transfer, DBT, to transfer funds to eligible beneficiaries in which of the following schemes? 1. PM Avas Yojana. 2. PM Krishi Sinchai Yojana. 3. PM Fasal Bima Yojana. 4. LPG Pahal Scheme, select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2. B. 1, 2, 3. C. 1, 2, 4. D. 1, 2, 3, 4. Solution. D. In rural Bharat, DBT has allowed the government to provide financial assistance effectively and transparently to farmers with lower transaction costs, be it for fertilizers or any of the other schemes including the PM Kisan Samman Nidhi, PM Fasal Bima Yojana, and PM Krishi Sinchai Yojana. The benefits received under the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act and Public Distribution System drive the rural demand supply chain. In urban India, the PM Avas Yojana and LPG Pahal Scheme successfully use DBT to transfer funds to eligible beneficiaries. Various scholarship schemes and the National Social Assistance Program use the DBT architecture to provide social security. DBT and the rehabilitation programs, such as the self-employment scheme for rehabilitation of manual scavengers, opens new frontiers that enable social mobility of all sections of society. 20. From free rations to nearly 80 crore people under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, fund transfers to all women Jan Dhan account holders and support to small vendors under PM Swanidhi, DBT helped the vulnerable to withstand the shock of the pandemic. 6. Kirit Parikh Committee, recently seen in news is related to a strengthened capital goods sectors. B. Development of mutual funds. C. Pricing regime for domestic natural gas. D. Reforms in criminal laws. Solution. C. The Union Cabinet recently approved significant changes in the pricing regime for domestic natural gas under the ambit of the Administered Price Mechanism, APM, which mainly applies to gas produced by legacy fields or nomination fields of National Oil Companies, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, ONGC Limited and Oil India Limited Oil. Nomination fields are acreages that the government awarded to ONGC and Oil before 1999, after which options became the basis of awarding oil and gas blocks. The revised pricing mechanism is based on recommendations of a panel headed by Kirit Parikh. Source. 7. Consider the following statements regarding Vibrant Villages Program, VVP. 1. The program aims to improve the quality of life of people living in identified border villages. 2. Promotion of social entrepreneurship, empowerment of youth and women through skill development is also one of the objectives of VVP. 3. The program also intends to promote cultural and traditional knowledge and heritage in the border. Areas. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. What is the Vibrant Villages Program? Comprehensive development of villages of blocks on northern border thus improving the quality of life of people living in identified border villages. This will help in encouraging people to stay in their native locations in border areas and reversing the out-migration from these villages, adding to improve security of the border. Under the centrally sponsored scheme, 2,967 villages in 46 blocks of 19 districts have been identified for comprehensive development. These villages are at the border in the states of Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh and the Union Territory of Ladakh. The aims of the scheme are to identify and develop the economic drivers based on local, natural, human and other resources of the border villages. Development of growth centers on the hub-and-spoke model through promotion of social entrepreneurship, empowerment of youth and women through skill development is also one of the objectives of VVP. Moreover, the program also intends to leverage tourism potential through promotion of local, cultural, traditional knowledge and heritage in the border areas, thus increasing the employment opportunities of the people in, as a result, stemming migration. Development of sustainable eco-agribusinesses on the concept of one village, one product through community-based organizations, cooperatives, SHGs, NGOs, etc. is also aimed at. 21. The district administration will prepare action plans with the help of gram panchayats for the identified villages to ensure 100% saturation of central and state schemes. The scheme envisages that drinking water, 24 times 7 electricity, connectivity with all weather roads, cooking gas, mobile and internet connectivity be made available in the border areas. Special attention will be given to solar and wind energy, tourist centers, multipurpose centers and health infrastructure and wellness centers. Source. A. Consider the following statements regarding the provisions of Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017. 1. It allows 26 weeks of paid leave after childbirth to biological and adoptive mothers. 2. The Act is applicable to all establishments employing 10 or more than 10 persons in factories, mines, plantation, shops and establishments and other entities. 3. Establishment having 50 or more employees shall have to provide fresh facility, either separately or along with common facilities. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. The Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017 amended Section 5 of the Erstwhile Act to allow 26 weeks of paid leave after childbirth, although only to biological mothers. The amendment also inserted Section 5-4, which said that adoptive or surrogate mothers legally adopting a child below 3 months will be entitled to a maternity benefit period of 12 weeks from the date the child is handed over to the mother. The act is applicable to all establishments employing 10 or more than 10 persons in factories, mines, plantations, shops and establishments and other entities. Establishments employing 50 or more employees are also required to provide fresh facilities, either separately or along with common facilities within a prescribed distance. Source. 9. Consider the following statements. 1. In India, the Department of Pharmaceuticals functions under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. 2. India's medical devices sector is regulated as per provisions under the Drugs and Cosmetics Act of 1940. 3. More than 2/3 of the medical devices currently sold in the country are imported. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 3. B. 1, 2. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. Department of Pharmaceuticals functions under the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. Nearly 80% of medical devices currently sold in the country are imported, particularly high-end devices. 22. India's medical devices sector has so far been regulated as per provisions under the Drugs and Cosmetics Act of 1940, and a specific policy on medical devices has been a long-standing demand from the industry. 10. Consider the following statements. 1. In India, the Radio Club of Bombay was the first to send out commercial radio transmission. 2. At present, the All India Radio functions under the jurisdiction of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. 3. At present, All India Radio is available to 100% of India's land area and all of its population. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2 only. B. 1, 2. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution B. After Guglielmo Marconi sent out the first radio transmission in 1895, it took over 2 decades for radio broadcasting to become commercially available. In India, the Radio Club of Bombay sent out the first commercial transmission in 1923. In the same year, the Calcutta Radio Club was started and a year later, radio broadcasts reached Madras with the Madras Presidency Radio Club. The ambitious Indian Broadcasting Company, IBC, came into existence in 1927. In 1930, the Indian State Broadcasting Service, ISBS, under the Department of Industries and Labour, commenced its operations on an experimental basis. Finally, on June 8, 1936, ISBS became All India Radio. A year later, AIR was brought under the Department of Communications, and 4 years later, under the Department of Information and Broadcasting, now called THE Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, under whose jurisdiction it remains till date. At the time of independence, AIR covered just 2% of India's land area and reached just 11% of its population. Today, with a network of over 262 radio stations, AIR is available to 92% of India's area and nearly all of its population. It broadcasts in 23 languages and 146 dialects, catering to India's diverse demographics and tastes. It also has an external services division which broadcasts in 11 Indian and 16 foreign languages, reaching out to more than 100 countries. FM broadcasting began in 1977 in Chennai and expanded during the 1990s. Today, AIR 18 FM stereo channels, largely targeting the urban audience. Source. 11. Consider the following statements. 1. The Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission ABDM aims to create a seamless online platform that will enable interoperability within the digital healthcare ecosystem. 2. The National Health Authority NHA is the implementing agency for the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission. 3. It will bridge the existing gap amongst different stakeholders of healthcare ecosystem through digital highways. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. 23. Solution D. The National Health Authority NHA is the implementing agency for the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission. The Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission ABDM aims to create a seamless online platform that will enable interoperability within the digital healthcare ecosystem. It will bridge the existing gap amongst different stakeholders of healthcare ecosystem through digital highways. The mission has been conceptualized as a set of digital building blocks. Each building block is seen as a digital public good that can be used by any entity in the digital health ecosystem and provides key capabilities that enable the ABDM vision. 12. Consider the following statements regarding Open Network for Digital Commerce, ONDC. 1. ONDC is an interoperable network that seeks to democratize digital commerce in India. 2. ONDC eliminates the need for buyers and sellers to use the same application and promotes the discoverability of local digital stores across industries. 3. The ONDC entity, a not-for-profit company incorporated under the Companies Act 2013, manages and operates the ONDC network. 4. ONDC has been endorsed by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, DPIIT, under the Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2, 3. B. 2, 3, 4. C. 1, 3, 4. D. 1, 2, 3, 4. Solution D. ONDC is an interoperable network based on the Venn protocol that anyone can piggyback on. It seeks to break down silos in digital commerce by enabling platforms of varying configurations, big or small, to connect and operate seamlessly on it. It comprises different entities called network participants, including buyer applications, seller applications, and gateways that perform the search and discovery function. Imagine a scenario where all the large e-commerce platforms, from food delivery to clothing and fashion to conveyance, are accessible in one place, along with your neighborhood startups, shops, and kirana stores. How does this help, and why is it significant? By moving the exchange of goods and services from a platform-centric approach to a network-centric approach, ONDC eliminates the need for buyers and sellers to use the same application and promotes the discoverability of local digital stores across industries. What is ONDC's inclusive governance approach? The ONDC entity, a not-for-profit company incorporated under Section 8 of the Companies Act 2013, manages and operates the ONDC network. It is responsible for building and maintaining the underlying infrastructure, common registries and protocols, as well as defining the rules of engagement and code of conduct for the network participants through the ONDC network policy and the ONDC network participant agreement. To what extent will the government be involved in ONDC? ONDC has been endorsed by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, DPIIT, under the Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry. DPIIT is not involved in ONDC's funding, but is at the forefront of its evangelization through light touch governmental oversight. To ensure a market plus community-driven approach to decision-making, the board includes representatives from banks, the government, and independent industry and civil society members. Source. 24. 13. Consider the following statements regarding Parakh Initiative. 1. Parakh has been set up as the organization under Central Board of Secondary Education. 2. Its mandate is to work on bringing the school examination boards across the states and the union territories on a common platform. 3. Parakh will act as a common platform for interaction of all concerned stakeholders in order to promote equity in performance and equivalence in assessment of students. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. Parakh has been set up as the organization under NCERT. It will work on bringing the school boards across the states and the union territories on a common platform. As a first step, a workshop on school assessments, examination practices and equivalence of boards across the country was organized by the Ministry of Education in Parakh in New Delhi. Parakh will act as a common platform for interaction of all concerned stakeholders in order to develop a holistic approach that ensures a fair assessment system which promotes equity in performance and equivalence in assessment of students. Source. 14. Which of the following is, are the objectives of Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana, PMSSY? 1. Correcting the imbalances in the availability of affordable healthcare facilities in the different parts of the country. 2. Providing universal access to public health services and universal immunization. 3. Augmenting facilities for quality medical education in the country. Select the correct answer code. A. 1 only. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution B. PMSSY was announced in 2003 with objectives of correcting regional imbalances in the availability of affordable, reliable tertiary healthcare services and also to augment facilities for quality medical education in the country. 15. Consider the following statements. 1. Ganga Parties are motivated and trained volunteers from among the local communities working for biodiversity conservation and cleanliness of the Ganga River. 2. Ganga Parties are constituted by the National Mission for Clean Ganga and the Wildlife Institute of India, NMCGB, under the Namami Gange program. 3. The United Nations has recognized the Namami Gange initiative as one of the top 10 world restoration flagships involved in reviving the natural world. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution D. 25. Ganga Pari Guardian, this is a task force of volunteers constituted by the National Mission for Clean Ganga and the Wildlife Institute of India, NMCGB, under the Namami Gange program to cover 8.61 billion square km of the river basin. Since 2014, Namami Gange has aimed to clean the river ecosystem and the villages around, home to 40% of India's population and 520 million and 2,500 species of flora and fauna. The United Nations in December 2022 recognized the initiative as one of the top 10 world restoration flagships involved in reviving the natural world. A project that has seen the central government invest $5 billion. Source. 16. Rank Commission, sometimes seen in news is related to a subcategorization of OBC. B. Agricultural marketing. C. Defense modernization. D. Denotified tribes, DNTs. Solution. D. Who are the notified, nomadic and semi-nomadic tribes? These are communities who are the most vulnerable and deprived. Denotified tribes, DNTs, are communities that were notified as being born criminal during the British regime under a series of laws starting with the Criminal Tribes Act of 1871. Nomadic and semi-nomadic communities are defined as those who move from one place to another rather than living at one place all the time. A National Commission for the Notified, Nomadic and Semi-Nomadic Tribes, NCDNT, was constituted in 2006 by the then government. It was headed by Bhupesh Sivaram and submitted its report in June 2008, in which it said, it is an irony that these tribes somehow escaped the attention of our constitution makers and thus got deprived of the constitutional support unlike scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. 17. The government organized Manadham Ki Gaurav Gatha program that was a tribute to which of the following movements in the Indian freedom struggle. A. Peasant movement. B. Movement of the working class. C. Tribal uprising. D. None of the above. Solution. C. The Prime Minister attended a public program, Manadham Ki Gaurav Gatha, at Mangal Hill, Banswara, Rajasthan, to pay homage to the sacrifices of the unsung tribal heroes and martyrs of the freedom struggle. Mangal Hill holds special importance for the Bhil community and other tribes of Rajasthan, Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. During the freedom struggle where Bhils and other tribes engaged in a long standoff with the British, more than 1.5 lakh Bhils rallied at Mangal Hill on the 17th of November 1913 under the leadership of Sri Govind Guru. British opened fire at this gathering, leading to Mangal massacre where approximately 1500 tribals were martyred. 18. Consider the following statements regarding census exercise in India. 1. The Census of India Act of 1948 provides the legal framework for carrying out the census. 2. The Constitution of India mentions when the census has to be carried out, or what the frequency of this exercise should be. 3. All the members of the United Nations follow the 10-year cycle for their census. How many of the above statements are correct? 26. A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 1 is correct. A census is constitutionally mandated in India. There are repeated references to the census exercise in the constitution in the context of reorganization of constituencies for parliament and state assemblies. But the constitution does not say when the census has to be carried out, or what the frequency of this exercise should be. The Census of India Act of 1948, which provides the legal framework for carrying out the census, also does not mention its timing or periodicity. There is, therefore, no constitutional or legal requirement that the census has to be done every 10 years. However, this exercise has been carried out in the first year of every decade, without fail, since 1881. Most other countries also follow the 10-year cycle for their census. There are countries like Australia that do it every 5 years. It is not the legal requirement but the utility of the census that has made it a permanent regular exercise. The census produces primary, authentic data that becomes the backbone of every statistical enterprise, informing all planning, administrative and economic decision-making processes. Source. 5. Science and technology. 1. Consider the following statements regarding LIDAR. 1. LIDAR is a remote sensing method that uses light in the form of a pulse laser to examine the surface of the Earth. 2. LIDAR can detect pollutant particles of carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and methane. 3. LIDAR can be used to create 3D elevation map of a particular land. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. D. LIDAR, which stands for light detection and ranging, is a remote sensing method that uses light in the form of a pulse laser to measure ranges, variable distances to the Earth. These light pulses, combined with other data recorded by the airborne system, generate precise, three-dimensional information about the shape of the Earth and its surface characteristics. LIDAR can be used to create 3D elevation map of a particular land. LIDAR wavelength is shorter. It operates in ultraviolet, visible region or near infrared. This helps to image the matter which is of the same size or larger than the wavelength. So LIDAR can detect pollutant particles of carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and methane. 2. Consider the following statements. 27. 1. Vitamin D works more as a hormone and is key to maintaining metabolic functions and immune system. 2. In the absence of vitamin D, the skeletal muscle is starved of energy, decreasing muscle mass. 3. The glucose absorbed from food is converted into glycogen and stored in the skeletal muscle to produce energy after the food consumed is digested. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 1, 2, 3. D. 2, 3. Solution. C. Skeletal muscles normally brim with energy, yet they starve in the absence of vitamin D, says recent research. This research demonstrates that glycogen stored in the skeletal muscles is not converted into a usable form of energy without vitamin D. Usually, the glucose absorbed from the food is converted into glycogen and stored in the skeletal muscle. This stored energy reserve is used by muscles to produce energy after the food consumed is digested. However, in the absence of vitamin D, the skeletal muscle is starved of energy, decreasing muscle mass. We are becoming aware that vitamin D works more as a hormone than is involved in a host of biochemical reactions. It is key to maintaining metabolic functions, immune system. 3. Consider the following statements regarding quantum computing. 1. Quantum computer works on the principle of superposition, which makes it possible for the qubit to exist in both 0 and 1 state simultaneously. 2. As more qubits are added, the processing capability of the quantum computer increases exponentially. 3. Building a quantum computer requires very cold temperatures and extreme isolation. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1, 2. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. D. Conventional computers store and process information in bits. A bit is the smallest unit of data that computers can handle. It can take just two values, 0 or 1, but only one of these at a time. A 0 would result in a certain set of instructions to be carried out, while a 1 would lead to a different set of instructions. All data in computers, including text, pictures and videos, are broken down into a sequence of 0s and 1s for purposes of storage and processing and can be reconstructed from these. A 2-bit system in a conventional computer can have 4 states, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, but again only one at a time. To go through each of these 4 states, the computer has to take 4 steps. A more powerful computer can speed up the process, but it would still have to go through the 4 steps. This is where the quantum computer starts to do things differently. Superposition makes it possible for the quantum bit, or a qubit as it is called, to exist in both 0 and 1 state simultaneously. Counterintuitive as it may appear, it can be 60% 0 and 40% 1 at the same time, or any other combination. Similarly, the 2-qubit system can be in all 4 states at the same time, some part 0, 0, some part 0, 1, some part 1, 0, and remaining 1, 1. What it means is that the quantum computer can go through these 4 states in one step, unlike the conventional computer that requires 4 steps. 28. As more qubits are added, the processing capability of the quantum computer increases exponentially. With just a few qubits, say 50, quantum computers can outpace traditional computers that perform a couple of billion operations per second. Apart from the challenges in building a quantum computer, requirements of very cold temperatures and extreme isolation, there is a significant risk of errors. The parallel processing happening in superposition states all lead to different results, only one of which is correct or desirable. In other situations, when the superposition breaks down, the final outcome is randomly selected from the range of possibilities. Source. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. Neurotoxicity occurs when exposure to natural or man-made toxic substances alters the normal activity of the nervous system. 2. Neurotoxins directly attack the respiratory tract of the body, thereby overpowering the oxygen concentration of the body. 3. Methane, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide are not considered as neurotoxic gases. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1, 2. C. 1, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. B. Neurotoxins are poisonous substances which can directly affect the nervous system. Neurotoxicity occurs when exposure to natural or man-made toxic substances alters the normal activity of the nervous system. These substances can eventually disrupt or even kill neurons or nerve cells, which are important for transmitting and processing signals in the brain and other parts of the nervous system. They directly attack the respiratory tract of the body, thereby overpowering the oxygen concentration of the body and then the nervous system as well. Methane, hydrogen sulfide, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide are common neurotoxic gases. While methane and carbon monoxide are odorless gases, hydrogen sulfide has a pungent odor and in high concentration it can be fatal for humans. Source. 5. The term dendrochronology denotes. A. Method of plant tissue culture used to produce clones of a plant. B. Method of determining the age of the tree. C. Production of multiples of plants in the absence of seeds. D. Alteration of the genome of a plant by the addition of new genetic material solution. B. The most common method of determining the age of the tree is dendrochronology, or tree ring dating, also called growth rings. Each year, roughly a tree adds to its girth, the new growth is called a tree ring. By counting the rings of a tree, the age can be determined. 6. Consider the following statements. 1. Air traffic controllers ATC monitor the location of aircraft in their assigned airspace by radar and communicate with the pilots by radio. 29. 2. International Air Transport Association ITA assigns code name for airlines and airports for easy identification. 3. Air traffic controller is the final authority for the safe operation of the aircraft and the pilot cannot deviate from the instructions given by ATC. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1, 3. C. 1, 2. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. Air traffic control ATC is a service provided by ground-based air traffic controllers who direct aircraft on the ground into a given section of controlled airspace and can provide advisory services to aircraft in non-controlled airspace. The primary purpose of ATC worldwide is to prevent collisions, organize and expedite the flow of air traffic, and provide information and other support for pilots. The pilot in command is the final authority for the safe operation of the aircraft and may, in an emergency, deviate from ATC instructions to the extent required to maintain safe operation of their aircraft. The Committee on Public Undertakings in its first report tabled in Parliament in January 2021 recommended changing the code name for the airport, assigned by Global Trade Body International Air Transport Association ITA. The ITA assigns a 2-character code name for airlines and a 3-character code for airports for easy identification. These are also fundamental to the smooth running of hundreds of electronic applications. 7. Consider the following statements. 1. Quantum technology is based on the principles of quantum theory, which explains the nature of energy and matter on the atomic and subatomic level. 2. National Mission on Quantum Technologies and Applications, nanometer QTA, is being implemented by the Department of Science and Technology, DST. 3. In India, the Center has declared quantum technology as a mission of national importance. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution D. Quantum technology is based on the principles of quantum theory, which explains the nature of energy and matter on the atomic and subatomic level. It concerns the control and manipulation of quantum systems, with the goal of achieving information processing beyond the limits of the classical world. In 2019, the Center declared quantum technology a mission of national importance. The government in its budget 2020 also announced a national mission on quantum technologies and applications, nanometer QTA, for a period of 5 years to be implemented by the Department of Science and Technology, DST. 8. The most common chemicals used for cloud seeding are 1. Dry ice. 2. Silver iodide. 3. Potassium iodide. 4. Sodium chloride. 3. Select the correct answer code. 1, 2, 4. B. 1, 2, 3. C. 2, 3, 4. D. 1, 2, 3, 4. Solution D. The most common chemicals used for cloud seeding include silver iodide, potassium iodide, and dry ice. After promising research, the use of hygroscopic materials, such as table salt, sodium chloride, is becoming more popular. 9. Consider the following statements regarding mixed reality. 1. Mixed reality involves the blending of real and virtual worlds. 2. It combines aspects of both virtual reality, VR, and augmented reality, AR. 3. Physical and virtual objects cannot coexist in mixed reality environments. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 3 is incorrect. Mixed reality, or MR specifically, involves the blending of real and virtual worlds. Put simply, the MR experience viewed in the head-mounted display combines aspects of both virtual reality, VR, and augmented reality, AR. The idea is to connect real environments to completely virtual ones. Physical and virtual objects may coexist in mixed reality environments and interact in real time. Mixed reality has been used in applications across fields including design, education, entertainment, military training, healthcare, product content management, and human-in-the-loop operation of robots. Source. 10. Consider the following statements. 1. In India, the National Cancer Awareness Day coincides with the birth anniversary of C. Veeraman. 2. The discovery of radium and polonium are known as the two most significant contributors to the fight against cancer. 3. Nuclear energy radiotherapy is one of the most widely used therapies for cancer treatment. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 2 only. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 3. Solution C. National Cancer Awareness Day focuses on creating awareness of early diagnosis, precautions, and treatment of cancer. India began National Cancer Control Program in 1975, focusing on establishing cancer treatment facilities in the nation. In 1984-85, the vision changed to focus on the early detection and prevention of cancer. 31. National Cancer Awareness Day was first announced in September 2014. This day coincides with the birth anniversary of the Nobel Prize winner Marie Curie, a scientist born in 1867. She discovered radium and polonium, which are known as the two most significant contributors to the fight against cancer. Marie Curie's work and discovery led to the development of nuclear energy radiotherapy that helps with cancer treatments. 11. Consider the following statements regarding stem cells. 1. They can divide over and over again to produce new cells. 2. As they divide, they can change into the other types of cells that make up the body. Which of the above statements are incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution D. A stem cell is a cell with a unique ability to develop into specialized cell types in the body. In the future, they may be used to replace cells and tissues that have been damaged or lost due to disease. Stem cells provide new cells for the body as it grows and replace specialized cells that are damaged or lost. They have two unique properties that enable them to do this. They can divide over and over again to produce new cells. As they divide, they can change into the other types of cells that make up the body. 12. Consider the following statements regarding mucormycosis. 1. Mucormycosis is a fungal infection caused by a group of molds called mucormycetes. 2. It affects the sinuses, the brain, and the lungs and can be life-threatening in diabetic and cancer patients. 3. Soil, plants, manure, and decaying fruits and vegetables are the common sources of infection. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution D. Mucormycosis is a serious but rare fungal infection caused by a group of molds called mucormycetes. These molds live throughout the environment. It is caused by exposure to mucor mold, which is commonly found in soil, plants, manure, and decaying fruits and vegetables. It affects the sinuses, the brain, and the lungs and can be life-threatening in diabetic or severely immunocompromised individuals, such as cancer patients or people with HIV/AIDS. 32. 6. International relations and organizations. 1. Consider the following statements regarding Interpol. 1. Interpol is an intergovernmental organization which helps police forces in all the member countries to better coordinate their actions. 2. It is headed by a Secretary General with its headquarters in Geneva, Switzerland. 3. It issues red notice RN that alerts police forces across the world about fugitives who are wanted internationally. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2, 3. B. 1, 3. C. 1, 2. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution B. The Interpol, or International Criminal Police Organization, is an intergovernmental organization which helps police forces in all the member countries to better coordinate their actions. According to the Interpol website, the organization enables member countries to share and access data on crimes and criminals and offers a range of technical and operational support. The Interpol General Secretary coordinates the organization's day-to-day activities. It is run by a Secretary General with its headquarters in Lyon, France. Interpol has a National Central Bureau, NCB, in each member country, which is the central point of contact for both the General Secretariat and the other NCBs around the world. Each NCB is run by police officials of that country and usually sits in the government ministry responsible for policing. Home Ministry in India. What is a red notice? Criminals or suspects often flee to other countries to await facing justice. A red corner notice or red notice RN alerts police forces across the world about fugitives who are wanted internationally. Interpol says red notices are issued for fugitives wanted either for prosecution or to serve a sentence. A red notice is a request to law enforcement worldwide to locate and provisionally arrest a person pending extradition, surrender, or similar legal action. RN is published by Interpol at the request of a member country. The fugitives may be wanted for prosecution or to serve a sentence. The country issuing the request need not be the home country of the fugitive. Interpol acts on the request of a country where the alleged crime has been committed. Is an RN a warrant of arrest? RN is only an international wanted person's notice. It is not an international arrest warrant. Interpol itself does not want individuals. They are wanted by a country or an international tribunal. 2. Consider the following statements regarding Financial Action Task Force, FATF. 1. Financial Action Task Force, FATF, is a United Nations affiliated watchdog monitoring money laundering, terror financing, and other threats to global financial networks. 2. The FATF relays signals to international financial and banking systems that there are increased risks in transacting with the country in realist. 3. To get out of the realist, the country has to fulfill tasks recommended by the FATF, such as confiscating properties of individuals associated with terrorist groups. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. 33. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution C. FATF is an international watchdog monitoring money laundering, terror financing, and other threats to global financial networks. The grey list signals to international financial and banking systems that there are increased risks in transacting with the country in question, impacting the country's economic growth. To get out of the grey list, a country has to fulfill tasks recommended by the FATF, such as confiscating properties of individuals associated with terrorist groups. 3. Consider the following statements. 1. The United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child, UNCRC, is a legally binding international agreement setting out the civil, political, economic, social, and cultural rights of every child. 2. India has signed, but has not yet ratified the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child, UNCRC. 3. Presently, India's Right to Education Act covers children from 6 to 18 years of age. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1. 3. B. 1 only. C. 1. 2. D. 2. 3. Solution. B. The United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child, UNCRC, is a legally binding international agreement setting out the civil, political, economic, social, and cultural rights of every child, regardless of their race, religion, or abilities. In 1992, India ratified the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child, which called for its signatories to ensure to the maximum extent possible the survival and development of the child. Presently, the country's Right to Education Act covers children from 6 to 14 years of age. 4. Consider the following statements regarding World Intellectual Property Organization, WIPO. 1. The World Intellectual Property Organization, WIPO, is one of the 15 specialized agencies of the United Nations, UN. 2. WIPO was established under TRIPS Agreement as a global forum for intellectual property, IP, services. 3. The predecessor to WIPO was the United International Bureau for the Protection of Intellectual Property. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 2. 3. B. 1. 3. C. 1. 2. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. B. WIPO is the global forum for intellectual property, IP, services, policy, information, and cooperation. Our mission is to lead the development of a balanced and effective international IP system that enables innovation and creativity for the benefit of all. Our mandate, governing bodies and procedures are set out in the WIPO Convention, which established WIPO in 1967. The predecessor to WIPO was the United International Bureau for the Protection of Intellectual Property, which had been established in 1893 to administer the Bern Convention for the Protection of Literary and Artistic Works and the Paris Convention for the Protection of Industrial Property. 34. WIPO was formally created by the Convention establishing the World Intellectual Property Organization, which entered into force on the 26th of April 1970. That date is commemorated annually as World Intellectual Property Day, which raises awareness of the importance of IP. 5. Consider the following statements regarding United Nations Democracy Fund UNDEF. 1. The large majority of UNDEF funds go to local civil society organizations. 2. UNDEF subsists entirely on voluntary contributions from governments. 3. UNDEF falls under the direct authority of the UN Secretary General. 4. India is among the top 10 biggest UNDEF donor countries. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1. 2. 3. B. 1. 3. 4. C. 2. 3. 4. D. 1. 2. 3. 4. Solution. D. UNDEF was created by UN Secretary General Kofi Annan in 2005 as the United Nations General Trust Fund to support democratization efforts around the world. UNDEF funds projects that empower civil society, promote human rights, and encourage the participation of all groups in democratic processes. The large majority of UNDEF funds go to local civil society organizations. UNDEF subsists entirely on voluntary contributions from governments. India is among the top contributors to the UN Democracy Fund, UNDEF, whose mission is to promote democracy across the world through local and international NGOs and civil society organizations, CSOs. Since UNDEF's inception in 2005, India has contributed over $32 million to it and remains its fourth largest contributor. As the Secretary General's Trust Fund located within the UN Secretariat, UNDEF falls under the direct authority of the UN Secretary General. The Secretary General is guided by the UNDEF Advisory Board, which consists of the 7 biggest UNDEF donor countries. As of 2010, the United States, India, Japan, Qatar, Germany, Australia, and Spain. Source. 6. Cape Town Convention, CTC, recently seen in news related to. A. Protect human health and the environment from anthropogenic emissions and releases of mercury. B. Ethical principles regarding human experimentation. C. Financing and leasing of aircraft, engines, and spare parts. D. Sustainable development goals. Solution. C. Cape Town Convention, CTC, is a 2001 treaty designed to smooth the growth of aviation by protecting the repossession rights of aircraft. The CTC treaty is the financing and leasing of aircraft, engines, and spare parts by reducing lessors risk and expanding legal predictability in these transactions, including the case of insolvency. India acceded to the CTC in 2018 but has not been ratified by the Parliament yet. As a result, Indian law prohibits any such recoveries once bankruptcy proceedings are initiated for a company, lawyers, and industry. 35. India has made it easier for lessors to take back planes if airlines default on payments after joining an international treaty known as the Cape Town Convention. But lack of proper legislation to enforce the treaty means India's bankruptcy law will supersede lessors' repossession requests. Source. 7. The COVID restrictions, known as Title 42, was introduced by China. B. Japan. C. United States. D. European Union. Solution. C. The United States Supreme Court dismissed a lawsuit in which Republicans attempted to preserve a program instituted by former President Donald Trump that allowed American officials to promptly deport hundreds of thousands of migrants to the U.S.-Mexico border. What is Title 42? The COVID restrictions, known as Title 42, were first implemented under Republican then-President Donald Trump in March 2020 at the beginning of the pandemic. At the time, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, said the order was needed to stem the spread of the coronavirus in crowded detention settings. Source. A. Consider the following statements regarding Arab League. 1. The member states of Arab League have pledged to cooperate on economic and military affairs. 2. The League makes decisions on a majority basis, but there is no mechanism to compel members to comply with resolutions. 3. All the Persian Gulf countries are members of Arab League. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. A. The League makes decisions on a majority basis, but there is no mechanism to compel members to comply with resolutions. The Arab League, formerly known as the League of Arab States, was established in 1945 with initially just 6 nations, Egypt, Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon, Saudi Arabia, and Syria. Currently, it has 22 member states, who have pledged to cooperate on economic and military affairs, among other issues. Iran is not a member of Arab League. Source. 9. Consider the following statements regarding Group of 5, G5 countries. 1. The Group of 5, G5 encompasses 5 nations which have joined together for an active role in the rapidly evolving international order. 2. The G5 nations work to promote dialogue and understanding between developing and developed countries. 3. India is not part of G5 countries. 36. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1. 3. B. 2. 3. C. 2 only. D. 1. 2. Solution. D. The Group of 5, G5 encompasses 5 nations which have joined together for an active role in the rapidly evolving international order. Individually and as a group, the G5 nations work to promote dialogue and understanding between developing and developed countries. The G5 seek to find common solutions to global challenges. The grouping includes Brazil, China, India, Mexico, and South Africa. 10. The Initiative on Critical and Emerging Technologies, ICET, that aims at co-producing jet engines, long-range artillery and infantry vehicles, is between India and A. Israel. B. United States. C. Russia. D. Japan. Solution. B. India and the US are discussing possibilities of co-producing jet engines, long-range artillery and infantry vehicles under the Initiative on Critical and Emerging Technologies, ICET, announced earlier this year. The INSEX is going to be a major initiative under ICET and the focus is firmly on advancing high-tech cooperation. Source. 11. Consider the following statements regarding exclusive economic zones, EEZs. 1. EEZ is the distance up to which a coastal nation has jurisdiction over the ocean, including both living and non-living resources. 2. It generally goes to 200 nautical miles beyond a nation's territorial sea. 3. Due to their relatively small size, most of the Pacific Island countries does not have any exclusive economic zones, EEZs. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 3 is incorrect. Despite their relatively small size and considerable distance from India, many of the Pacific Island countries have large exclusive economic zones, EEZs. EEZ is the distance up to which a coastal nation has jurisdiction over the ocean, including both living and non-living resources. It generally goes to 200 nautical miles or 230 miles, around 370 kilometers beyond a nation's territorial sea. Source. 37. 12. Consider the following statements regarding East Asia Summit. 1. Not all the members of ASEAN are members of East Asia Summit. 2. India is a member of East Asia Summit. 3. Since its inception, India has not hosted the East Asia Summit. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 1 is incorrect. What is the East Asia Summit? Beginning in 2005, 16 participating countries comprised this grouping, with their first meeting in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. These members were 10 Asian countries, Australia, China, India, Japan, New Zealand, and the Republic of Korea. ASEAN's 10 member countries are Brunei, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, Myanmar, the Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, and Vietnam. Simply, the ICAS is an initiative and refers to the annual meeting of heads of state, governments of these countries, where they are able to discuss common concerns and interests. Its creation was based on the idea of enhancing cooperation among East Asian countries and those in the neighboring regions. Six priority areas of cooperation were identified: environment and energy, education, finance, global health issues and pandemic diseases, natural disaster management, and Asian connectivity. India has not hosted the East Asia Summit. 7. Quality. 1. Article 340 of the Constitution of India provides for the appointment of a commission to investigate the conditions for the improvement of A. Transgender persons. B. Disabled population. C. Women and children. D. Backward classes. Solution. D. Article 340 of the Constitution of India provides for the appointment of a commission to investigate the conditions for the improvement of backward classes. The President may by order appoint a commission comprising of such persons that he thinks fit to investigate the conditions and background of socially and educationally backward classes that lie within the territory of India. Article 340 of the Constitution resulted in two backward classes commissions. Kaka Kalilkar Commission 1953-1955. Mandal Commission 1978-80. 2. Consider the following statements regarding split verdict delivered by Supreme Court. 38. 1. A split verdict is passed when the Supreme Court bench cannot decide one way or the other in a case, either by a unanimous decision or by a majority verdict. 2. Split verdicts can happen even when the bench has an odd number of judges. 3. In case of a split verdict, the case is heard by a larger bench. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2. 3. B. 1. 2. C. 1. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. C. A split verdict is passed when the bench cannot decide one way or the other in a case, either by a unanimous decision or by a majority verdict. Split verdicts can only happen when the bench has an even number of judges. This is why judges usually sit in benches of odd numbers 3, 5, 7, etc. For important cases, even though two judge benches, known as division benches, are not uncommon. In case of a split verdict, the case is heard by a larger bench. The larger bench to which a split verdict goes can be a three judge bench of the High Court, or an appeal can be preferred before the Supreme Court. 3. Consider the following statements regarding parole. 1. Parole is a system of releasing a prisoner with suspension of the sentence. 2. It is seen as a matter of right, to be granted periodically irrespective of any reason and merely to enable the prisoner to retain family and social ties. Which of the above statements is incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. B. Parole is a system of releasing a prisoner with suspension of the sentence. The release is conditional, usually. Subject to behavior and requires periodic reporting to the authorities for a set period of time. A broadly similar concept is furlough, which is given in case of long-term imprisonment. Why furlough is seen as a matter of right, to be granted periodically irrespective of any reason and merely to enable the prisoner to retain family and social ties, parole is not a matter of right and may be denied to a prisoner even when he makes out a sufficient case. The Supreme Court in Asfaq v. Estate of Rajasthan and others in 2017 said the main purpose of parole and furlough, a conditional temporary release, but with the benefit that such a period of release is considered part of the total sentence, is to afford a convict the opportunity to solve their personal and family problems and enable them to maintain their links with society. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. The governor is the head of the state's executive power and acts only on the advice of the council of ministers on all matters. 2. While the governor does not have to see anyone's advice while appointing the chief minister, he can appoint a minister only on the recommendation of the chief minister. 3. The governor can determine the time needed for a party to prove its majority or which party must be called first to do so in an assembly. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2 only. B. 1. 2. 39. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 3. Solution. C. The position, role, powers, and conditions of office of the governor are described in Articles 153-161 of the Constitution. The position of governor is similar to that of the President of the Union. He is the head of the state's executive power, and barring some matters, acts on the advice of the Council of Ministers, which is responsible, in accordance with the parliamentary system, to the state legislature. The governor is appointed by the President on the advice of the central government and, therefore, acts as the vital link between the Union and the state governments. The governor enjoys certain powers to give or withholding assent to a bill passed by the state legislature or determining the time needed for a party to prove its majority, or which party must be called first to do so, generally after an assembly. Article 164-1 deals with the appointment of the chief minister and other ministers. While the governor does not have to seek anyone's advice while appointing the chief minister, he can appoint a minister only on the recommendation of the chief minister. The governor has no power to pick anyone he chooses to make a minister. He can appoint a minister only on the advice of the chief minister. 5. Consider the following statements. 1. The official language committee is a statutory committee whose duty is to review the progress made in the use of Hindi for the official purposes of the union and submit a report to the president. 2. The official language act 1963 provides for the continuance of English indefinitely as official language along with Hindi for the official purposes of the union and for transaction of business in parliament. 3. The official language committee is mandated to recommend the medium of instruction in universities and professional institutions. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 3. B. 1 only. C. 1. 2. D. 2. 3. Solution. C. The official language committee is a statutory committee constituted under Section 4 in the Official Language Act 1963. Its duty is to review the progress made in the use of Hindi for the official purposes of the union. Submit a report to the president. The act makes it obligatory for the president to issue directions in accordance with the whole or any part of the report, Section 4.4. It can thus be seen that the committee's recommendations are required to be acted upon. The committee is chaired by the Union Home Minister. Article 343 of the Constitution declares that Hindi in Devanagari script shall be the official language of the union. Parliament enacted the Official Languages Act in 1963, providing for the continuance of English indefinitely as official language along with Hindi for the official purposes of the union and for transaction of business in parliament. The committee is not mandated to recommend the medium of instruction in universities and professional institutions. Further, since parliament has declared by law that English shall continue along with Hindi, a statutory committee constituted under the very act has no mandate to recommend the discontinuation of English. India has two major groups of languages, the Indo-European language group and the Dravidian language group. Hindi belongs to the former and Tamil, more ancient than Sanskrit, belongs to the latter. 40. 6. Consider the following statements. 1. All government bills automatically go to parliamentary committees for examination. 2. Any member of the parliament can oppose the introduction of a bill by stating that it initiates legislation outside the legislative competence of the parliament. Which of the above statements is incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. A. Any member of the parliament can oppose the introduction of a bill by stating that it initiates legislation outside the legislative competence of the parliament. The real opportunity for proving a bill's constitutionality arises when a parliamentary committee is examining it. Government bills do not automatically go to committees for examination. Ministers get an option to refer their bill to a select committee. 7. Consider the following statements. 1. According to Article 200 of the Constitution of India, the governor can reserve a bill for consideration of the president only if the governor forms an opinion that the bill would endanger the position of the High Court. 2. The Constitution of India does not mention the grounds on which a governor may withhold his assent to a bill. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. C. Article 200 of the Constitution provides certain options for the governor to exercise when a bill reaches him from the assembly. The provision concerned makes it clear that the bill can be reserved for the consideration of the president only if the governor forms an opinion that the bill would endanger the position of the High Court by whittling away its powers. The Constitution does not mention any other type of bill which is required to be reserved for the consideration of the president. The fact that the Constitution does not mention the grounds on which a governor may withhold assent to a bill shows that this power should be exercised by the governor extremely sparingly and after very careful consideration of the consequences of such action. 8. The seminal ruling in Kesavananda Bharathi, in which the Supreme Court laid down the basic structure, doctrine completes 50 years. Consider the following statements in this context. 1. Since 1973, the year of the Kesavananda Bharathi judgment, the Constitution has been amended more than 50 times. 2. Since 1973, not in all cases the Supreme Court has upheld constitutional amendments that have been challenged on grounds of violation of the basic structure doctrine. 3. Since 1973, the Supreme Court has struck down a constitutional amendment entirely more than once. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 2. 3. 41. C. 1. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. A. Since 1973, the year of the Kesavananda Bharathi judgment, the Constitution has been amended more than 60 times. In these 5 decades, the Supreme Court has tested constitutional amendments against the doctrine of basic structure in at least 16 cases. In 9 of these 16 cases, the Supreme Court has upheld constitutional amendments that have been challenged on grounds of violation of the basic structure doctrine. 6 of these cases relate to reservations, including the quota for other backward classes, OBC, and economically weaker section, EWS, and reservations in promotions. The Supreme Court has struck down a constitutional amendment entirely just once, the Constitution 99th Amendment Act, 2014, which established the National Judicial Appointments Commission, NJAC. In 6 instances since 1973, including the case of Anandaruling itself, the Supreme Court has partially struck down a constitutional amendment. In all these cases, the provision that was struck down related to denial of judicial review. Source. 9. The famous Kyoto Holohan v. Statute and other cases related to it, National Judicial Appointments Commission, NJAC, B. Anti-Defection Law. C. Land-Sealing Laws. D. Constitution of Administrative Tribunals. Solution, B. Kyoto Holohan v. Statute and others, 1992, the Supreme Court upheld the Constitution, 52nd. Amendment Act that introduced the 10th schedule of the so-called Anti-Defection Law in the Constitution. The only portion of the amendment that was struck down was the one that stated that the decisions of the Speaker relating to disqualification cannot be judicially reviewed. Source. 10. Consider the following statements. 1. The Constitution of India prohibits the court from initiating proceedings against the governor or the president for any act done in exercise of their powers. 2. The Constitution of India does not fix any timeline for the governor to decide the question of assent to a bill. 3. Governor's action of withholding assent to a bill cannot be struck down as unconstitutional by the courts. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 2. 3. B. 1. 2. C. 1 only. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. B. Article 361 of the Constitution prohibits the court from initiating proceedings against the governor or the president for any act done in exercise of their powers. They enjoy complete immunity from court proceedings. 42. It may be noted that the governor, while declaring that he withholds assent, will have to disclose the reason for such refusal. If the grounds for refusal disclose nullify or extraneous considerations or other ways, the governor's action of refusal could be struck down as unconstitutional. This point has been settled by a constitution bench of the Supreme Court in Ramesh Prasad Amos. V.S. Union of India and ANR. Since the constitution does not fix any timeline for the governor to decide the question of assent, he can wait for any length of time without doing anything. Not fixing any timeline does not and cannot mean that the governor can indefinitely sit on the bill that has been passed by an assembly. 11. Consider the following statements regarding model code of conduct. 1. The model code of conduct is a set of norms that has been evolved with the consensus of political parties who have consented to abide by the principles embodied in the said code. 2. The model code of conduct comes into force immediately on the announcement of the election schedule by the election commission. 3. The rule ceases to exist on the polling day. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1 only. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. A. The model code of conduct is a set of guidelines issued by the election commission of India for the conduct of political parties and candidates during elections, mainly with respect to speeches, polling day, polling booths, portfolios, election manifestos, processions, and general conduct. This set of norms has been evolved with the consensus of political parties who have consented to abide by the principles embodied in the said code in its letter and spirit. The model code of conduct comes into force immediately on the announcement of the election schedule by the commission for the need of ensuring free and fair elections. Its main purpose is to ensure that ruling parties, at the center and in the states, do not misuse their position of advantage to gain an unfair edge. Source. 12. Consider the following statements regarding the word sovereignty used in India's constitution. 1. The word sovereignty appears in the beginning of the preamble to the constitution of India. 2. Sovereignty is mentioned in the constitution under fundamental duties. 3. It is also mentioned in the oaths for positions like the chief justices, union ministers, and members of parliament under the third schedule of the constitution. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. The word sovereignty appears in the beginning of the preamble to the Constitution of India, is the first attribute of the independent Republic of India. Its placement is the first among the core principles of the Republic underlines its importance in the Constitution. Sovereignty is mentioned in the Constitution under fundamental duties, which are to be followed by all Indian citizens but cannot be legally enforced. Article 51(8)(c) states that it is the duty of all citizens to uphold and protect the sovereignty, unity, and integrity of India. 43. It is also mentioned in the oaths for positions like the chief justices, union ministers, and members of parliament under the third schedule. I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established, that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India. Source. 13. Consider the following statements. 1. An MLA has the right to participate in proceedings of the House regardless of pendency of any petitions for disqualification. 2. At present, the 10th schedule of the Constitution of India protects defectors as long as 1/3 of the members of the political party form a separate group. 3. The freedom of expression of legislators in the House or intra-party dissent fall within the purview of anti-defection laws. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1 only. B. 1. 2. C. 1. 3. D. 2. 3. Solution. A. Passing a unanimous judgment on the various issues related to the split in Shiv Sena in June 2022, the Supreme Court made strong observations about the role of the then Governor of Maharashtra and the Speaker of the Legislative Assembly. Not intervening in the proceedings, the SC said the issue of disqualification ought to be decided as per established procedures in law, and the Speaker is the appropriate authority for this under the 10th schedule of the Constitution, which lays down the anti-defection law. The court also clarified that an MLA has the right to participate in proceedings of the House regardless of pendency of any petitions for disqualification. Paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule protected defectors as long as 1/3 of the members of the political party form a separate group. It was removed by the Constitution, 91st Amendment Act, 2003, which came into effect on January 1, 2004. The court said that the power of the governor to act without the aid and advice of the council of ministers is of an extraordinary nature and must be exercised with circumspection within the limits of law. The court said that as per provisions of the Representation of the People Act, an association of individuals calling itself a political party has to be registered with the Act. The freedom of expression of legislators in the House or intra-party dissent cannot fall within the purview of anti-defection laws. Source. 14. Which of the following conditions is unnecessary for the issue of writ of certiorari in India? 1. There should be an officer or a tribunal having the judicial authority as per law to decide on cases affecting the rights of people. 2. Such an officer or a tribunal must have acted in excess of judicial power or without requisite jurisdiction. Select the correct answer code. A. 1 only 44. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2 solution. C. Certiorari is basically a tool for judicial control and restraint. As mentioned above, it is issued by the Supreme Court or the High Court to quash an order passed by an inferior court, tribunal, or quasi-judicial authority whenever the authority has acted in excess of its power or without requisite jurisdiction or has violated the principles of natural justice. It is corrective in nature and is aimed at preventing overstepping by the judicial authorities. For the issuance of the writ of certiorari, the following conditions must be fulfilled. The existence of an officer or a tribunal having the judicial authority as per law to decide on the cases affecting the rights of people. Such an officer or a tribunal must have acted in excess of judicial power or without requisite jurisdiction or in violation of the principles of natural justice. 15. Consider the following statements. 1. An ordinance promulgated by the President cannot negate a constitutional bench judgment of the Supreme Court of India. 2. The Legislative Assembly of the National Capital Territory of Delhi, NCTD, has competence over all entries in List 2 and List 3 of the 7th Schedule to the Constitution of India. 3. The executive power of NCTD is coextensive with its legislative power. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 3 is correct. On May 19, 2023, the President of India exercised legislative power under Article 123 of the Constitution during the period Parliament was in recess to promulgate the Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi Amendment Ordinance, 2023 Ordinance. The ordinance negates a constitutional bench judgment of the Supreme Court of India, which was delivered on May 11, that brought services under the Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, NCTD. While interpreting Article 239A(3), the court ruled, inter alia, that these were the points, the Legislative Assembly of the NCTD has competence over entries in List 2 and List 3, except for expressly excluded entries of List 2, entries 1, 2, 18 are excluded, the executive power of NCTD is coextensive with its legislative power. That is, it shall extend to all matters with respect to which it has power to legislate. The Union of India has executive power only over 3 entries in List 2 over which the NCTD does not have legislative competence, entries 1, 2, 18. Thus, essentially, the court interpreted that out of the 66 entries in List 2, the state list, while the executive power of the government of NCTD covers 63 entries, that of the Union of India is restricted to the remaining 3, public order, entry 1, police, entry 2, and land, entry 18. Consequently, executive power over services, entry 41, can be exercised exclusively by the government of the NCTD. This interpretation of the court is consistent with the wordings in Article 239A(3)(a). But this 45. Interpretation was negated by the Union of India, acting through its Council of Ministers under Article 74, by triggering extraordinary legislative power of the President under Article 123 in the promulgation of an ordinance on May 19. Source. 16. Consider the following statements regarding review petition. 1. The Constitution of India does not mention anything about review petition. 2. Usually a review takes place to correct grave errors that have resulted in the miscarriage of justice. 3. It is not necessary that only parties to a case can seek a review of the judgment on it. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 1 is incorrect. A judgment of the Supreme Court becomes the law of the land according to the Constitution. However, the Constitution under Article 137 gives the Supreme Court the power to review any of its judgments or orders. This departure from the Supreme Court's final authority is entertained under specific narrow grounds. So, when a review takes place, the law is that it is allowed not to take fresh stock of the case but to correct grave errors that have resulted in the miscarriage of justice. Who can file a review petition? It is not necessary that only parties to a case can seek a review of the judgment on it. As per the Civil Procedure Code and the Supreme Court rules, any person aggrieved by a ruling can seek a review. However, the court does not entertain every review petition filed. It exercises its discretion to allow a review petition only when it shows the grounds for seeking the review. Source. 17. Consider the following statements. 1. Forum shopping involves litigants or lawyers attempting to deliberately move their case to a particular judge or court where they think the judgment could be more favorable. 2. Bench hunting refers to petitioners managing to get their cases heard by a particular judge or court to ensure a favorable order. 3. Supreme Court ruling does not bar the practice of forum shopping or bench hunting. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 3 is incorrect. What is practice of forum shopping? When litigants or lawyers attempt to deliberately move their case to a particular judge or court where they think the judgment could be more favorable, they are said to be forum shopping. 46. Even the US and UK courts have criticized the practice of forum shopping as something to be avoided or prohibited. Last year, on March 22nd, an SC bench of Justice S. Abdul Nazir and Justice Krishna Murari in the case of Vijay Kumar Ghai versus State of WB termed forum shopping as a disreputable practice by the courts that has no sanction and paramountcy in law. On March 28th, the Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh High Court in Dr. Khair Al-Nisar and Oz versus UT of Jammu and Kashmir and Oz imposed costs worth ₹1 lakh on petitioners for indulging in forum shopping by filing multiple petitions before different wings of the court, albeit having the same cause of action. Similarly, bench hunting refers to petitioners managing to get their cases heard by a particular judge or court to ensure a favorable order, the court added. Source. 18. Consider the following statements regarding Union Public Service Commission, UPSC. 1. All expenses for the UPSC are paid from the Consolidated Fund of India. 2. UPSC does not involve in the appointment of officers on promotion or deputation. 3. UPSC advises the government of India on any matter referred to the commission by the President of India. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 2 is incorrect. All expenses for the UPSC are paid from the Consolidated Fund of India. Its functions, according to the website, include conduct examinations for appointment to the services of the union, direct recruitment by selection through interviews, appointment of officers on promotion, deputation, absorption, framing and amendment of recruitment rules for various services imposed under the government, disciplinary cases relating to different civil services, advising the government on any matter referred to the commission by the President of India. Source. 19. Consider the following statements regarding ordinances. 1. Rejection of an ordinance would imply the government has lost majority. 2. If an ordinance makes a law, the parliament is not competent to enact under the constitution, it shall be considered void. 3. If an ordinance lapses, the only option for the government is to reissue or prorogate it. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. The ordinance may lapse earlier if the president withdraws it or if both houses pass resolutions disapproving it. Rejection of an ordinance would, however, imply the government has lost majority. 47. If an ordinance makes a law, the parliament is not competent to enact under the constitution, it shall be considered void. Article 213 deals with the broadly analogous powers of the government to promulgate, withdraw an ordinance when the state legislature is not in session. An ordinance is valid for 6 weeks or 42 days from the date on which the next session starts. If the two houses start their sessions on different dates, the later date will be considered, say the explanations in Articles 123 and 213. If, for whatever reason, an ordinance lapses, the only option for the government is to reissue or prorogate it. Source. 8. History, Art and Culture. 1. Manamadurai pottery recently earned a geographical indication, D tag. It belongs to Kerala. B. Telangana. C. Tamil Nadu. D. Andhra Pradesh. Solution. C. These pots have put this village in Tamil Nadu on the global map. Manamadurai in Shivagangai district is known for pottery making. The Manamadurai pottery recently earned a geographical indication, D tag. The Wangai River in which is the clay used for the Manamadurai pottery. Pot making requires expertise as the bottom has to be perfectly round. The circumference of the pot in the neck should be proportionate so that the pot sits flat on the ground. The right proportion of mud, clay and heating makes this product very strong. The main raw materials for making these pots are soil and water. A unique type of clay is sourced from water bodies like Nerukulam, Nathapakki, Sundaranadipu, Sikalapur to make these pots. Source. 2. Consider the following pairs. Literary work author. 1. Harshacharita Bilhana. 2. Vikramankadeva Charitamana. 3. Rajatarangini Kalhana, which of the above pairs is correctly matched. A. 1. 3. B. 2. 3. C. 3 only. D. 1. 2. Solution. C. 48. Harshacharita was a biography of the Indian rural Harshavarna, a Sanskrit writer who wrote the first historical biography containing vivid descriptions of society and nature in Sanskrit in 640 CE. Bilhana, 11th century, composed the epic Vikramankadeva Charita. Kalhana wrote the history of Kashmir, the Rajatarangini, in Sanskrit in the 12th century. Source. 3. Consider the following statements regarding Jallianwala Bagh massacre. 1. At Jallianwala Bagh, people gathered for a public meeting against the arrest of Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Saifuddin Kichu for opposing the Ilbert bill. 2. Hunter committee was set up to investigate the Jallianwala Bagh incident. 3. Rabindranath Tagore gave up his knighthood as a response to the incident. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 3. B. 2. 3. C. 1. 2. D. 3 only. Solution. B. April 13th saw celebrations for the Sikh festival of Baisakhi, which marks the onset of spring and the harvest of winter crops. Simultaneously, the movement for independence from British rule had been steadily gaining ground. By 4 p.m., many gathered for a public meeting against the arrest of Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Saifuddin Kichu for opposing the rule act. Without giving the crowd any warning to disperse, Dai ordered his troops to fire. Indian leaders expressed their anger and protested in response to the killings. Notably, Nobel laureate poet Rabindranath Tagore gave up his knighthood. A committee named Hunter Committee was set up to investigate the Jallianwala Bagh incident. Source. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. India has more than 40 UNESCO World Heritage Sites. 2. Majority of the UNESCO World Heritage Sites in India are cultural heritage sites. 3. The Ancient Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains Act, 1958 is the sole act that provides for the protection of India's heritage sites. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 2 only. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 3. Solution. B. India has 40 World Heritage Sites, 7 Natural World Heritage Sites, 32 Cultural World Heritage Sites, and 1 Mixed World Heritage Site. The Ancient Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains Act, 1958, and the Antiquities and Art Treasures Act, 1972, provide for the protection of the country's heritage. 49. Source. 5. Janjatiya Gaurav Divas is celebrated to mark the birth anniversary of Sidhu and Kanhu Murmu. B. Birsa Munda. C. Rani Galileo. D. Alluri Sitaram Raju. Solution. B. November 15th is celebrated as Janjatiya Gaurav Divas to mark the birth anniversary of tribal freedom fighter. Birsa Munda, from year 2021 onwards, who was not only a freedom fighter but also social reformer and led tribal movement, namely Alluri, revolt against exploitative systems of British colonial government. He is also known as Dhati Abba as he encouraged tribals to understand their cultural roots and observe unity. 6. Consider the following statements regarding Mangalagiri Saris and Fabrics. 1. Mangalagiri Saris and Fabrics are produced by performing handicraft weaving in the state of Andhra Pradesh. 2. It has received the geographical indication tag. 3. The unique feature of Mangalagiri fabric is that it does not undergo any process of dyeing. 4. The Nizam design is a characteristic of the fabric. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 2. 3. C. 1. 2. 4. D. 2. 3. 4. Solution. C. Mangalagiri Saris and Fabrics are produced by performing handicraft weaving in Mangalagiri, a town in Guntur district of the Indian state of Andhra Pradesh. It was registered as one of the handicrafts in the geographical indication from Andhra Pradesh by Geographical Indications of Goods, Registration and Protection Act 1999. The Mangalagiri fabric is produced by weaving with the help of two looms from Kumbh Yan by woven woof interlacing. The fabric then undergoes the process of dyeing. The Nizam design is another characteristic of the fabric. 50. 7. Consider the following statements regarding the history of civil service exams in India. 1. Prior to the establishment of Civil Service Commission, civil servants for India were nominated by the East India Company. 2. Thomas Macaulay Committee recommended that civil servants should be selected through a competitive exam. 3. Satyendranath Tagore became the first Indian to clear the civil service examination. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. The UPSC has its genesis in the Civil Service Commission set up by the British government in 1854. Prior to this, civil servants for India were nominated by the East India Company and then trained at Haileybury College in London. However, following a report by Lord Thomas Macaulay, it was decided that instead of nominations, civil servants should be selected through a competitive exam. Thus, the Civil Service Commission was set up, and for some years, exams were held only in London. It was a decade later, in 1864, that Satyendranath Tagore, brother of Rabindranath Tagore, became the first Indian to clear the exam. The exam started being held in India only from 1922, after the First World War. Source. 51. 9. States. 1. Which of the following is the ethnic community of Assam? A. Gond. B. Deel. C. Ahom. D. Adi. Solution. C. The Ahom or Thai Ahom is an ethnic group from the states of Assam and Arunachal Pradesh. The members of this group are mixed descendants of the Thai people who reached the Brahmaputra Valley of Assam in 1228 and the local indigenous people who joined them over the course of history. Sukapa, the leader of the Thai group and his 9,000 followers established the Ahom Kingdom, 1228-1826 CE, which controlled much of the Brahmaputra Valley in modern Assam until 1826. 10. Agriculture. 1. In the last few years, the government has undertaken which of the following initiatives in the urea sector? 1. Mandatory to coat all indigenously manufactured and imported urea with neem oil. 2. Replacing 50 kg urea bags with 10 kg ones. 3. Launch of liquid nano urea by the Indian Farmers Fertilizer Cooperative IFFCO. Select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. B. In May 2015, the center made it mandatory to coat all indigenously manufactured and imported urea with neem oil. This was followed by replacing 50 kg bags with 45 kg ones in March 2018 and the launch of liquid nano urea by the Indian Farmers Fertilizer Cooperative IFFCO in June 2021. 2. Consider the following statements regarding nutrient-based subsidy NBS scheme. 1. Nutrient-based subsidy NBS scheme was introduced against the earlier product-specific subsidy regime. 2. Under NBS, the government fixed a per kilogram subsidy for each fertilizer nutrient, nitrogen N, phosphorus P, potash K, and sulfur S. 3. Linking subsidy to nutrient content aims to promote balanced fertilization by discouraging farmers from applying too much urea, the ammonium phosphate DAP, and muriate of potash MOP. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1, 2. B. 2, 3. C. 1, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. D. Under NBS, the government fixed a per kilogram subsidy for each fertilizer nutrient, nitrogen N, phosphorus P, potash K, and sulfur S. This was against the earlier product specific subsidy regime. 52. Linking subsidy to nutrient content was intended to promote balanced fertilization by discouraging farmers from applying too much urea, the ammonium phosphate DAP, and muriate of potash MOP. These are fertilizers with high content of a single nutrient, urea 46% N, DAP 46% P plus 18% N, and MOP 60% K. NBS was expected to induce product innovation, besides more use of complex fertilizers, having lower concentrations of N, P, K, and S in different proportions, and SSP containing only 16% P but also 11% S. Source. 3. Consider the following statements. 1. Rice exports from India have been mainly driven by basmati rice exports. 2. India's basmati rice exports are mainly to the Persian Gulf countries. 3. India is the world's top producer and exporter of cotton. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1, 2. B. 2 only. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. B. Basmati exports are mainly to the Persian Gulf countries and, to some extent, the US and UK. Non-basmati shipments are more diversified, with the destinations spread across Asia, Bangladesh, China, Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Vietnam, UAE and Iraq, and Africa, from Senegal, Ivory Coast and Benin to Somalia and Madagascar. It's non-basmati that has made India the biggest rice exporter, ahead of Thailand. Cultivation of genetically modified BT cotton and high global prices has enabled India to become the world's top producer, ahead of China, and number 2 exporter, after the US, of the natural fiber. Source. 4. Which of the following are considered as ex-situ crop residue management, CRM? 1. Use of paddy straw as feedstock for 2G ethanol plants. 2. Use of paddy straw for biomass power projects. 3. Incorporation of paddy straw in the soil using heavy machinery. 4. Use of paddy straw for co-firing in thermal power plants. Select the correct answer code. A. 2, 3, 4. B. 1, 2, 3. C. 1, 2, 4. D. 1, 2, 3, 4. Solution. C. The Commission for Air Quality Management in National Capital Region and Adjoining Areas, CAQM, had developed a framework and action plan for the effective prevention and control of stubble burning. The framework action plan includes in-situ management, i.e., incorporation of paddy straw and stubble in the soil using heavy subsidized machinery, supported by crop residue management, CRM, scheme of the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Ex-situ CRM efforts include the use of paddy straw for biomass power projects and co-firing in thermal power plants, and a feedstock for 2G ethanol plants, feedstock in CBG plants, fuel in industrial boilers, waste to energy, WTE plants, and in packaging materials, etc. 5. Consider the following statements regarding millets. 1. Millets are climate smart crops that are drought resistant, growing in areas with low rain and fertile soil. 53.2. They are hardier than other cereals. 3. They are less extractive for the soil and can revive soil health. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1, 2. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. D. Millets, which fell out of fashion a few decades ago, have received renewed attention as crops that are good for nutrition, health, and the planet. Millets are climate smart crops that are drought resistant, growing in areas with low rain and fertile soil. They are hardier than other cereals, more resilient to changes in climate, and require less water to cultivate, as much as 70% less than rice, and less energy to process, around 40% less than wheat. Since they need fewer inputs, they are less extractive for the soil and can revive soil health. Additionally, their genetic diversity ensures that rural diversity is preserved. 6. Consider the following statements. 1. In the last 5 years, sunflower oil constituted the maximum quantity of India's edible oil imports. 2. The majority of the edible oil consumed in India is produced domestically. 3. More than 50% of India's sunflower oil is consumed in South India. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 3 is correct. India consumes 23.5-24 million tons amount of cooking oil annually, out of which 13.5-14 amount is imported and the balance 9.5-0 empty produced from domestically cultivated seed. Roughly 70% of the country's sunflower oil consumption is in the south, with Maharashtra 10-15% and other states making up the rest. One reason for the geographical skew has to do with sunflower being traditionally grown in Karnataka, Telangana, and Maharashtra. 54. Black Sea Grain Initiative Agreement between Russia and Ukraine signed on July 22. The deal, brokered by the UN and Turkey, facilitated the safe navigation of vessels carrying grain and foodstuffs from free designated Ukrainian ports. Source. 11. Defense and Security. 1. Consider the following statements regarding Defense Cyber Agency, DCYA. 1. The Defense Cyber Agency, DCYA, is a tri-service command of the Indian Armed Forces. 2. The DCYA draws personnel from all three branches of the Armed Forces. 3. The head of the DCYA is the Chief of Defense Staff, CDs. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1, 3. B. 1, 2. C. 1 only. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution. B. The Defense Cyber Agency, DCYA, is a tri-service command of the Indian Armed Forces. Headquartered in New Delhi, the agency is tasked with handling cybersecurity threats. The DCYA draws personnel from all three branches of the armed forces. The head of the DCYA is an officer of 2-star rank and reports to the chief of defense staff CDs through the integrated defense staff IDs. 2. Operation Kaveri, recently seen in news, is related to evacuate Indian citizens during Russian invasion of Ukraine, help fleeing Hindus and Sikhs from Afghanistan, evacuate Indians stuck in Sudan. D. None of the above. Solution. C. Operation Kaveri, launched to evacuate Indians stuck inside war-torn Sudan. The operation involved the Indian Air Force and the Indian Navy, coordinated by the Ministry of External Affairs. Source. 3. Operation Shakti and Operation Smiling Buddha are related to a combined operation against Naxalites. B. Capture a golden temple. C. India's nuclear bomb test. D. Fleeing Hindus and Buddhists from Afghanistan. Solution. C. On May 11, 1998, India conducted 3 nuclear bomb test explosions at the Indian Army's Pokhran test range. 2 days later, on May 13, 2 more bombs were tested. Codenamed Operation Shakti, literally, strength, these tests would display India's capability to build fission and thermal nuclear weapons with yields up to 200 kilotons, helping India enter the highly guarded club of countries with capability to deploy nuclear weapons. 55. However, Pokhran 2, as a series of tests is more popularly known, was also the culmination of a long journey that began back in the 1940s-50s. On May 18, 1974, India carried out its first nuclear test at the Pokhran test site. Pokhran I, codenamed Operation Smiling Buddha, would be billed as a peaceful nuclear explosion with few military implications. Source. 4. The Garuda Shakti exercise is a bilateral joint special force exercise between India and Japan. B. Sri Lanka. C. Nepal. D. Indonesia. Solution D. The Garuda Shakti exercise is a bilateral joint special force exercise between India and Indonesia. This joint military exercise is being organized as part of the bilateral defense cooperation between Indonesia and India. It has been held since 2012, involving para special force of the Indian Army. 12. Reports and indices. 1. The Global Multidimensional Poverty Index, MPI, is released by World Economic Forum. B. Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, C. World Bank. D. United Nations Development Program, UNDP, Solution D. As many as 41.5 people excited poverty in India during the 15-year period between 2005-06 and 2019-21, out of which 2/3 excited in the first 10 years and 1/3 in the next 5 years, according to the Global Multidimensional Poverty Index, MPI. The report is produced by the United Nations Development Program, UNDP, and the Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative, OPHI. 2. World Press Freedom Index, recently seen in news, is released annually by World Press Club. B. UNESCO. C. Council of Europe. D. Reporters Without Borders. Solution D. In the 2023 edition of the World Press Freedom Index, released annually by the non-profit organization Reporters Without Borders, India has slipped 11 places to the 161st rank out of 180 countries. Reporters Without Borders or Reporters Sans Frontières in French is a global media watchdog headquartered in Paris, France, and it publishes a yearly report on press freedom in countries across the world. Recognized as a public interest organization in France since 1995, RSF has consultative status with the United Nations, UNESCO, the Council of Europe and the International Organization of Francophonie, OIF. 56. Source. 3. Consider the following statements. 1. Food Price Index, FPI, is a weighted average of world prices of a basket of food commodities with a base period 2014-16. 2. Food Price Index, FPI, is released by International Food Policy Research Institute, IFPRI. 3. India's agri exports in recent times have been powered by marine products, rice and sugar. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1 only. B. 1, 3. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution B. Both agricultural exports from imports into India have scaled new highs in the fiscal year that ended March 31, 2023. The UN Food and Agriculture Organization's Food Price Index, FPI, crashed from an average of 119.1 points in 2013-14 to 90 points in 2015-16. The FPI, a weighted average of world prices of a basket of food commodities over a base period value 2014. 16 equals 100, recovered to 102.5 points by 2020-21, and further to 133 points in 2021-22 and 139.5 points in 2022-23. India's agri-exports have, in recent times, been powered by three items, marine products, rice and sugar. Source. 4. Consider the following statements regarding Multidimensional Poverty Index, MPI. 1. Multidimensional Poverty Index, MPI, is released by World Bank. 2. The Global MPI constructs on indicators spanning health, education and standard of living. 3. The MPI ranges from 0 to 1, and higher values imply higher poverty. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1, 2. B. 2 only. C. 2, 3. D. 1, 3. 57. Solution C. Multidimensional Poverty Index, MPI. The report produced by the United Nations Development Program, UNDP, and the Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative, OPHI. The Global MPI constructs a deprivation profile of each household and person through 10 indicators spanning health, education and standard of living. All indicators are equally weighted within each dimension. The Global MPI identifies people as multidimensionally poor if their deprivation score is 1/3 or higher. The MPI is calculated by multiplying the incidence of poverty and the average intensity of poverty. The MPI ranges from 0 to 1, and higher values imply higher poverty. 13. Maps places. 1. The countries bordering United Arab Emirates, UAE are. 1. Oman. 2. Iran. 3. Kuwait. 4. Saudi Arabia. Select the correct answer code. A. 1, 2, 3. B. 2, 3, 4. C. 1, 4. D. 1, 2, 4. Solution C. 2. Arrange the following islands from north to south. 1. Senkaku Island. 2. Kuril Island. 3. Takeshima Island. Select the correct answer code. A. 3, 1, 2. B. 2, 3, 1. C. 2, 1, 3. D. 1, 2, 3. Solution B. 58. 3. Which of the following African countries border Indian Ocean? 1. Zambia. 2. Somalia. 3. Kenya. 4. Ethiopia. Select the correct answer code. A. 2, 3, 4. B. 2, 3. C. 1, 2, 3. D. 1, 3, 4. Solution B. 4. Which of the following Central Asian countries border China? 1. Tajikistan. 2. Uzbekistan. 3. Kyrgyzstan. 4. Kazakhstan. Select the correct answer code. A. 2, 3, 4. B. 1, 2, 3. C. 1, 3, 4. D. 1, 2, 4. Solution C. 59. 5. The under construction Zodiac Tunnel, recently in news connects between Jammu and Srinagar. B. Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. C. Guwahati and Taman. D. Manali and Keelong. Solution B. The under construction Zodiac Tunnel, which will establish all weather connectivity between the union territories of Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. The Zodiac Tunnel will be India's longest road tunnel and is expected to be Asia's longest bidirectional tunnel, boasting a length of 14.15 kilometers. Source. 6. The Red Sea is a strip of water and an inlet of the Indian Ocean occupying the area separating the continent of Africa from Asia. The countries bordering the Red Sea are. 1. Egypt. 2. Djibouti. 3. Ethiopia. 4. Yemen. 5. Saudi Arabia. Select the correct answer code. 60. A. 1, 2, 3, 4, B. 1, 2, 3, 5, C. 2, 3, 4, 5, D. 1, 2, 4, 5. Solution D. The 6 countries that border the Red Sea are the following: Saudi Arabia, Yemen, Egypt, Sudan, Eritrea, and Djibouti. 14. Miscellaneous. 1. Handball rule, recently seen in news, is mainly associated with which sport? A. Cricket. B. Hockey. C. Table tennis. D. Football. Solution D. After the offside, handball is the most contested rule in football. A handball is an offense in football which is used when an outfield player touches the ball with their hand or arm, or a goalkeeper outside of their penalty box. Source. 2. Consider the following statements regarding Mother Tongue Survey of India, MTSI. 1. The Mother Tongue Survey of India is a project that surveys the mother tongues, which are returned consistently across two and more census decades. 2. It was carried out by Union Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA. 3. It also documents the linguistic features of the selected languages. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 261. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution D. The Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA, has completed the Mother Tongue Survey of India, MTSI, with field videography of the country's 576 languages. According to the report, the Mother Tongue Survey of India is a project that surveys the mother tongues, which are returned consistently across two and more census decades. It also documents the linguistic features of the selected languages. 3. Consider the following statements. 1. Domestic violence is a punishable offense under Indian law. 2. Domestic violence is a violation of human rights. 3. Intimate partner violence is not recognized as domestic violence under the Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005 PWDBA. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 3. B. 1. 2. C. 2 only. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution B. Intimate partner violence is also recognized under the Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005 PWDBA as a kind of domestic violence. Domestic violence is a punishable offense under Indian law. It is a violation of human rights. 4. Kartik Mayappan, who secured hat-trick in the 2022 T20 World Cup, represents Sri Lanka. B. Zimbabwe. C. United Arab Emirates. D. Namibia. Solution C. UAE spinner Kartik Mayappan became the first bowler to take a hat-trick in the 2022 T20 World Cup. 5. Who among the following is known as Pali Express? A. P. V. Sindhu. B. Sakshi Malik. C. Hima Das. D. P. T. Usha. Solution D. India star sprinter P. T. Usha is fondly called the Pali Express. 62. Insta Current Affairs Quiz. June 2023. www.insightsonindia.com/insights. Table of Contents. 1. Economy. 2. Ecology and Environment. 11. 3. Geography. 15. 4. Government Schemes and Programs. 25. 5. Science and Technology. 31. 6. International Relations and Organizations. 37. 7. Polity. 44. 8. History, Art and Culture. 54. 9. States. 55. 10. Agriculture. 55. 11. Defense and Security. 60. 12. Reports and Indices. 62. 13. Maps, Places. 62-14. Miscellaneous. 65. 1. 1. Economy. 1. Tampon tax is a tax applied on luxury products. B. Sin goods. C. Electrical vehicles. D. Menstrual product solution. D. Concern about period poverty has fueled campaigns globally calling for the end of the so-called tampon tax, which refers to consumption levies such as value added tax, VAT, that most countries charge on items such as sanitary pads, tampons, panty liners and menstrual cups. Since Kenya became the first country to scrap VAT on sanitary pads and tampons in 2004, at least 17 countries have followed suit. Source. 2. Consider the following statements regarding RBI Retail Direct, RBI Road Scheme. 1. RBI Retail Direct, RBI Road Scheme facilitates investment in government securities by individual investors. 2. The scheme provides investors an opportunity to invest only in primary market and not in secondary market. 3. Sovereign gold bonds, SGB, are kept out of the scheme. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution A. Only statement 1 is correct. Reserve Bank of India, RBI, Retail Direct Scheme. The scheme provides investors an opportunity to invest in government securities in a safe and hassle-free way in the primary and secondary market. Government securities under the scheme includes Government of India Treasury Bills, T-Bills, Government of India Dated Securities, Dated G-Sec State Development Loans, SDLs, Sovereign Gold Bonds, SDB. Retail Direct Scheme offers retail investors the opportunity to buy securities directly and free of charges. Individual retailers can open a Bills Securities account called a Retail Direct Bills, RDG, account with RBI to participate in the buying and selling of government securities. Source. 3. Consider the following statements regarding Angel Tax. 1. Angel Tax did the use of unaccounted money through the subscription of shares of a closely held company at a value that is higher than the fair market value of the firm's shares. 2. Angel Tax was introduced through an amendment of Income Tax Act. 3. Investment in unlisted Indian startups by any foreign country attracts Angel Tax. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. 2. D. None. Solution B. Statement 3 is incorrect. Investors from 21 countries including the US, the UK, France, Australia, Japan have been exempted from the levy of Angel Tax for investment in unlisted Indian startups. Countries like Singapore, Netherlands and Mauritius, which constitute the major chunk of foreign direct investment in India, have not been included in the exemption list. What are the notified categories of exempted investors from Angel Tax? Central Board of Direct Taxes, CBDT, listed excluded entities which include those registered with SEBI's category like FDI, endowment funds, pension funds and broad-based pooled investment vehicles where the number of investors in such vehicle or fund is more than 50, and the residents of 21 specified nations, including the US, UK, Australia, Germany and Spain. Other nations mentioned in the notification are Austria, Canada, Czech Republic, Belgium, Denmark, Finland, Israel, Italy, Iceland, Japan, Korea, Russia, Norway, New Zealand and Sweden. What is Angel Tax? Which startups were excluded from its levy? The Finance Act 2023 had amended Section 56(2)(b) of the Income Tax Act. The provision, colloquially known as the Angel Tax, was first introduced in 2012 to deter the generation and use of unaccounted money through the subscription of shares of a closely held company at a value that is higher than the fair market value of the firm's shares. The provision stated that when an unlisted company, such as a startup, receives equity investment from a resident for issue of shares that exceeds the face value of such shares, it will be counted as income for the startup and be subject to income tax under the head income from other sources for the relevant financial year. Source. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. A loan turns into a non-performing asset (NPA) if the interest or installment remains unpaid for a period of more than 60 days. 2. To avoid classifying a loan as an NPA, banks adopt the evergreening of loans. 3. An accommodative monetary policy strictly restricts banks from indulging in evergreening of loans. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution A. Only statement 2 is correct. The process of evergreening of loans, a form of zombie lending, is typically a temporary fix for a bank. If an account turns into a non-performing asset (NPA), banks are required to make higher provisions which will impact their profitability. A loan turns into a non-performing asset (NPA) if the interest or installment remains unpaid even after the due date and remains unpaid for a period of more than 90 days. So, to avoid classifying a loan as an NPA, banks adopt the evergreening of loans. In the past, many banks had indulged in dressing up bad loans and given additional funds to companies who didn't have the capacity to repay. An accommodative monetary policy creates an enabling environment for weak banks to evergreen loans to zombies and keeps them alive. The RBI has been following an accommodative policy since 3 March 2020 when the pandemic struck the country. Most of the evergreening has happened in public sector banks which subsequently led to a jump in NPAs. Source. 5. Consider the following statements regarding CIBIL score. 1. CIBIL score is a 3-digit numeric summary of one's credit history that ranges from 100 to 900. 2. It involves credit history across loan types and credit institutions over a period of time. 3. CIBIL score is provided by the Credit Information Bureau India Limited, which is authorized by the Reserve Bank of India (RBI). How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 1 is incorrect. A Credit Information Bureau India Limited (CIBIL) score is a 3-digit numerical summary of one's credit history, which involves an individual's credit payment history across loan types and credit institutions over a period of time, ranging from 300 to 900. The CIBIL score is provided by the Credit Information Bureau India Limited, a credit rating agency which is authorized by the Reserve Bank of India (RBI). Source. 6. Typically, GDP is calculated by adding up all expenditures in the economy. Arrange the following components in the decreasing order in terms of their contribution to India's annual GDP. 1. Private final consumption expenditure (PFCE). 2. Government final consumption expenditure (GFCE). 3. Gross fixed capital formation (GFCF). 4. Net export. Select the correct answer code. A. 1234. B. 3124. C. 1324. D. 1342. Solution C. Typically, GDP is calculated by adding up all expenditures in the economy. These expenditures are broadly categorized in 4 groups. 1. All the money Indians spend in their personal capacity, from buying an ice cream to watching a movie to buying a TV or car. This is called the PFCE. Such expenditures account for 55% minus 60% of India's annual GDP. 2. All the money the government spend on their daily uses, paying salaries, etc. This is called government final consumption expenditure (GFCE) and this accounts for 10% of India's GDP. 3. All the money spent by private companies and governments towards building productive capacities in the economy. Say a firm buying desktops for its employees or the government spending money on building a road. This is called the gross fixed capital formation (GFCF) and this accounts for 30% minus 32% of the GDP. 4. Net exports are the net of all the money that Indians receive by exporting goods and services and minus all the money they spent on importing goods and services. More often than not, India's imports are more than its exports. Asset net exports component is negative and drags down overall GDP. Source. 7. Consider the following statements regarding deposit insurance and credit guarantee corporation (DICGC). 1. DICGC is a wholly owned subsidiary of the RBI. 2. DICGC insures all deposits such as savings, fixed, current and recurring, including accrued interest. 3. Regional rural banks (RRBs) and cooperative banks are outside the purview of DICGC cover. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 3 is incorrect. What is DICGC? DICGC is a wholly owned subsidiary of the RBI and provides deposit insurance. The deposit insurance system plays an important role in maintaining the stability of the financial system, particularly by assuring the small depositors of the protection of their deposits in the event of a bank failure. The deposit insurance extended by DICGC covers all commercial banks, including local area banks, labs, payments banks, PBs, small finance banks, SFBs, regional rural banks, RRBs, and cooperative banks that are licensed by the RBI. DICGC ensures all deposits to savings, fixed, current and recurring, including accrued interest. Each depositor in a bank is insured up to a maximum of 5 lakh rupees for both principal and interest amount held by them as on the date of liquidation or failure of a bank. The earlier insurance cover provided by DICGC was as 1 lakh. However, the limit of insurance cover for depositors in insured banks was raised to 5 lakh rupees in 2020. Source. 8. Consider the following statements regarding token tax. 1. The token tax is a tax levied on spot currency conversions, with the intention of business incentivizing short-term currency speculation. 2. It is also known as a financial transactions tax, FTT. 3. It is seen as a means of controlling the stability of a given country's currency. Which of the above statements is are correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. The token tax is a tax levied on spot currency conversions, with the intention of business incentivizing short-term currency speculation, named after economist James Tobin. In contrast to a consumption tax paid by consumers, the token tax is meant to apply to financial sector participants as a means of controlling the stability of a given country's currency. It is more formally known today as a financial transactions tax, FTT. 5. 9. Consider the following statements regarding gross domestic product, GDP, and gross value added, GVA. 1. GDP equals GVA plus subsidies provided by the government, taxes earned by the government. 2. If the taxes earned by the government are more than the subsidies it provides, the GDP will be higher than GVA. Which of the above statements is are incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. A. When one is looking at quarterly data, it is best to look at GVA data because it is this which is the observed data. The GDP is derived by looking at the GVA data. The GDP and GVA are related by the following equation. GDP equals GVA plus taxes earned by the government, subsidies provided by the government. As such, if the taxes earned by the government are more than the subsidies it provides, the GDP will be higher than GVA. 10. Consider the following statements regarding gross domestic product, GDP, and gross value added, GVA. 1. Only GDP data is used to measure national income and not GVA. 2. GDP captures the total demand in the economy. 3. By looking at the GVA growth, one can understand which sector of the economy is robust and which is struggling. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 1 is incorrect. What do GDP and GVA mean? GDP and GVA are two main ways to ascertain the country's economic performance. Both are measures of national income. The GDP measures the monetary measure of all final goods and services, those that are bought by the final user, produced in a country in a given period. The GDP does this by adding up the total expenditures in the economy. In other words, it looks at who spent how much. That is why GDP captures the total demand in the economy. The GVA calculates the same national income from the supply side. It does so by adding up all the value added across different sectors. According to the RBI, the GVA of a sector is defined as the value of output minus the value of its intermediary inputs. This value added is shared among the primary factors of production, labor and capital. By looking at the GVA growth, one can understand which sector of the economy is robust and which is struggling. 11. Consider the following statements regarding cost to company, CTC. 1. Cost to company, CTC, is a company spending on hiring and sustaining the services of an employee. 2. Usually the take-home salary of an employee will be higher than the CTC. 3. CTC is lower for contract employment when compared to permanent employment. Which of the above statements is are correct? A. 1. 2. 6. B. 1. Only. C. 1. 3. D. 2. 3. Solution. C. Cost to company, CTC, indicates the total amount of expenses a company organization spends on an employee during 1 year. It is calculated by adding salary to the cost of all additional benefits an employee receives during the service period. To put it in simpler terms, CTC is a company spending on hiring and sustaining the services of an employee. The CTC can include many elements in addition to salary, wages, such as healthcare, pension allowances for housing, travel and entertainment. Apparently, the cost to the company, CTC, is lower for contract employment when compared to permanent employment. 12. Consider the following statements. 1. General agreement on tariffs and trade GATT obligates countries not to impose tariffs beyond bound rates. 2. Bound rate is the maximum rate of duty tariff that can be imposed by the importing country on an imported commodity. 3. Bound rate agreed for any commodity at WTO is same for all the members of WTO. 4. General agreement on tariffs and trade GATT allows countries to deviate from their trade obligations on grounds of national security. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution. C. Statement 3 is incorrect. Bound rate is the maximum rate of duty tariff that can be imposed by the importing country on an imported commodity. Here, each country commits itself to a ceiling on customs duties tariff on a certain number of products. These rates vary from country to country and commodity to commodity, but no country can raise duties above the bound rate it has committed, and the rate of customs duty actually applied may be lower than the bound rate. General agreement on tariffs and trade GATT obligates countries not to impose tariffs beyond bound rates. Article 21 of GATT, which allows countries to deviate from their trade obligations on grounds of national security. Specifically, Article 21 BE of GATT allows a country to take any action which it considers necessary for the protection of its essential security interests taken in time of war or other emergency in international relations. 13. To revise and strengthen the monetary policy framework in India, RBI chooses to target retail inflation because 1. Wholesale inflation does not generally reflect price movements in all wholesale markets. 2. Wholesale inflation does not capture price movements in non-commodity producing sectors like services, which constitute close to 2/3 of economic activity in India. 7. 3. Wholesale price index WPI often reflect large external shocks and as such, the wholesale inflation rate is often subject to large revisions. Select the correct answer code. A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. In January 2014, an expert committee of the RBI submitted its report on the ways to revise and strengthen the monetary policy framework in India. It chose to target retail inflation. Here's why. Firstly, the committee pointed out that wholesale inflation does not capture price movements in non-commodity producing sectors like services, which constitute close to 2/3 of economic activity in India. This corresponds to the point made earlier about how WPI and CPI are different. Secondly, it pointed out that wholesale inflation does not generally reflect price movements in all wholesale markets. This happens because price quotations for some important commodities such as milk, LPG, etc. are taken from retail markets. Thirdly, movements in WPI often reflect large external shocks and as such, the wholesale inflation rate is often subject to large revisions. 14. The surplus in the current account in India can happen when 1. Record inflow of foreign direct investment and foreign portfolio investment. 2. Net services receipts increases sequentially. 3. Contraction in the trade deficit. 4. Growth in remittances by Indians employed overseas. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution. C. Foreign direct investment and foreign portfolio investment are part of the capital account. 15. Consider the following statements regarding wholesale inflation. 1. Wholesale inflation does not capture price movements in non-commodity producing sectors like services, which constitute close to 2/3 of economic activity in India. 2. Wholesale inflation does not generally reflect price movements in all wholesale markets. 3. Wholesale price index WPI often reflect large external shocks and as such, the wholesale inflation rate is often subject to large revisions. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. Wholesale inflation does not capture price movements in non-commodity producing sectors like services, which constitute close to 2/3 of economic activity in India. 8. Wholesale inflation does not generally reflect price movements in all wholesale markets. This happens because price quotations for some important commodities such as milk, LPG, etc. are taken from retail markets. Movements in WPI often reflect large external shocks and as such, the wholesale inflation rate is often subject to large revisions. 16. Consider the following statements regarding stock exchange route with respect to share buyback. 1. Under the stock exchange route, a company can buy back shares only on the stock exchanges having nationwide trading terminals. 2. In this method, the promoters or persons in control of a company are allowed to participate in the buyback. Which of the above statements is are incorrect? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. B. The Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, has decided to phase out the buyback of shares of listed companies through the exchange route. What is the stock exchange route? Under the stock exchange route, a company can buy back shares only on the stock exchange is having nationwide trading terminals. The buyback of shares is made only through the order matching mechanism. In this method, the promoters or persons in control of a company are not allowed to participate. What is buyback by a tender offer? A tender offer means an offer by a company to buy back its own shares or other specified securities through a letter of offer from the holders of the shares or other specified securities of the company. The buyback is done on a proportionate basis for the buyback ratio, and the additional shares tendered over and above the prescribed buyback ratio get accepted if there are any unaccepted shares. It is a fixed price buyback offer. 17. Consider the following statements regarding National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development, NaBFID. 1. NaBFID has been set up as a development financial institution, DFI, to support the development of long-term infrastructure financing in India. 2. NaBFID was set up through an executive order. 3. NaBFID shall be regulated and supervised as an all-India financial institution, AIFI, by the Reserve Bank of India. 4. NaBFID is funded by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways and does not have the power to issue bonds to raise money. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution B. Statement 1 and 3 are correct. The National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development, NaBFID Act 2021, received the assent of the President on March 28, 2021 and has come into force WAF, April 19, 2021. Accordingly, NaBFID has been set up 9. As a development financial institution, DFI, to support the development of long-term infrastructure financing in India. NaBFID shall be regulated and supervised as an all-India financial institution, AIFI, by the Reserve Bank under Sections 45L and 45N of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. NaBFID was set up in 2021 by an Act of the Parliament, the National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development Act 2021, with the essential objectives of addressing the gaps in long-term non-recourse finance for infrastructure development, strengthening the development of bonds and derivatives markets in India, and sustainably boosting the country's economy. The National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development, NaBFID, said it has raised 10,000 crore rupees by issuance of listed bonds in its maiden issuance. Source. 18. Consider the following statements regarding the impact of external aids on Indian economy. 1. It brings in foreign currency that is useful to bridge the balance of payments deficit. 2. It causes crowding out effect in the domestic market, which is not favorable to the domestic borrowers. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution A. If external aid is a grant or coming without interest, no better way to finance the deficit if we ignore the inflationary effects. When the domestic market has limited amount of funds, and if the government desires to borrow a large share of it to finance the fiscal deficit, it tends to raise the demand for funds in the market. This shoots the market interest rate for the funds and causes problems to the domestic investors who now have to pay a higher interest rate to avail the same loan. If the same money is borrowed from abroad, the crowding out effect doesn't occur. 19. Bank balance sheets may become healthier due to 1. Central banks' asset quality reviews. 2. Mandates for stress assets recognition and write-offs by commercial banks. 3. Loan recoveries under the insolvency and bankruptcy code. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. Bank balance sheets have become healthier over the past few years thanks to the central bank's asset quality reviews, mandates for stress assets recognition and write-offs by commercial banks, as well as loan recoveries under the insolvency and bankruptcy code. 20. Consider the following statements. 1. A barrier to trade is a government-imposed restraint on the flow of international goods or services. 10. 2. Capping foreign direct investment in sensitive sectors is a major example of trade barrier. 3. Unreasonable tax on imports is a trade barrier. Which of the above statements is correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1 only. C. 1. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution C. A barrier to trade is a government-imposed restraint on the flow of international goods or services. The most common barrier to trade is a tariff, a tax on imports. Tariffs raise the price of imported goods relative to domestic goods, goods produced at home. An import quota is a type of protectionist trade restriction that sets a physical limit on the quantity of goods that can be imported into a country in a given period of time. FDI is related to the capital sector and overall investment policy of the nation. FDI is not considered a trade component. 2. Ecology and environment. 1. Consider the following statements. 1. The World Environment Day, led by International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, has been held annually on June 5th. 1. The date for World Environment Day was chosen during the 1972 Stockholm Conference on the Human Environment. 3. Stockholm Conference on the Human Environment is considered to be the first world conference to make the environment a major issue. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 1 is incorrect. The World Environment Day, led by the United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP, has been held annually on June 5th, since 1973. The date was chosen by the UN General Assembly during the historic 1972 Stockholm Conference on the Human Environment, considered to be the first world conference to make the environment a major issue. Source. 2. Consider the following statements. 1. Microplastics are plastics that are less than 5 mm in diameter. 2. Primary microplastics are tiny particles designed for commercial use, such as in cosmetics or textiles. 3. Secondary microplastics are particles that are product of the breakdown of larger plastic items due to exposure to sun radiation or ocean waves. How many of the above statements are correct? 11. A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. Most modern plastics are derived from fossil fuel-based chemicals like natural gas or petroleum. However, recently, variants made from renewable materials, such as corn or cotton derivatives, have also emerged. Microplastics, officially defined as plastics less than 5 mm in diameter. There are two categories of microplastics. Primary microplastics are tiny particles designed for commercial use, such as in cosmetics or textiles. On the other hand, secondary microplastics are particles that are product of the breakdown of larger plastic items due to exposure to environmental factors such as sun radiation or ocean waves. Source. 3. Consider the following statements regarding ground level ozone. 1. Ground level ozone is a colorless gas that forms up to 2 miles above the ground. 2. Ground level ozone is called a secondary pollutant, since it is produced when two primary pollutants react in sunlight and stagnant air. 3. It is highly stationary and does not travel long distances due to wind. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 3 is incorrect. What is ground level ozone? Also known as tropospheric ozone, ground level ozone is a colorless and highly irritating gas that forms just above the earth's surface up to 2 miles above the ground. Notably, it's not directly emitted into the air but rather produced when two primary pollutants react in sunlight and stagnant air. These two primary pollutants are nitrogen oxides, NOx, and volatile organic compounds, VOCs. Therefore, ground level ozone is called a secondary pollutant. Ground level ozone is likely to breach safety standards on hot summer days in urban areas, but can also reach unhealthy levels during colder months. The pollutant can also travel long distances due to wind and affect rural areas also. Source. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. Nitrogen oxides, NOx, and volatile organic compounds, VOCs, are considered as primary pollutants. 2. Nitrogen oxides, NOx, is completely emitted from human activities and there are no known natural sources of nitrogen oxides. 3. Volatile organic compounds, VOCs, are emitted from gasoline combustion and upstream oil and gas production. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. 12. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 2 is incorrect. Nitrogen oxides, NOx, and volatile organic compounds, VOCs, are considered as primary pollutants. NOx and VOCs come from natural sources as well as human activities. About 95% of NOx from human activity comes from the burning of coal, gasoline and oil in motor vehicles, homes, industries and power plants. VOCs from human activity come mainly from gasoline combustion and marketing, upstream oil and gas production, residential wood combustion, and from the evaporation of liquid fuels and solvents. Source. 5. Consider the following statements regarding biological diversity heritage sites, BHSs. 1. Biodiversity heritage sites, BHS, are areas that are unique, ecologically fragile ecosystems having rich biodiversity comprising species richness, high animism, presence of rare, endemic and threatened species. 2. A site is declared as biological diversity heritage site as per the provisions of Biological Diversity Act. 2002. 3. The central government in consultation with state governments declare biodiversity heritage sites. 4. BHS declaration marks the voluntary participation of communities in protection and conservation of biodiversity. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution C. Statement 3 is incorrect. Biodiversity heritage sites (BHS) are areas that are unique, ecologically fragile ecosystems having rich biodiversity comprising of any one or more of the components such as species richness, high endemism. Presence of rare, endemic and threatened species, keystone species, species of evolutionary significance, by ancestors of domestic cultivated species or land races or their varieties, past preeminence of biological components represented by fossil beds and having cultural or aesthetic values. BHS declaration marks the voluntary participation of communities in protection and conservation of biodiversity, which helps in expanding the reach of conservation. Section 37 of the Biological Diversity Act. As per the section, the state governments are empowered to notify in the official gazette, in consultation with local bodies, areas of biodiversity importance as biodiversity heritage sites. Under subsection 2 of section 37 of the BD Act, the state government in consultation with the central government may frame rules for the management and conservation of BHS. 6. Consider the following statements regarding Miyawaki plantation method. 1. This method involves planting 2 to 4 different types of indigenous trees within every square meter. 2. The plants absorb the dust particles of the area and also help in regulating surface temperature. 3. The plants used in the Miyawaki method are not self-sustaining and require regular maintenance like manuring and watering. 13. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 3 is incorrect. What is the Miyawaki plantation method? Named after Japanese botanist Akira Miyawaki, this method involves planting 2 to 4 different types of indigenous trees within every square meter. In this method, the trees become self-sustaining and they grow to their full length within 3 years. The methodology was developed in the 1970s with the basic objective to densify green cover within a small parcel of land. The plants used in the Miyawaki method are self-sustaining and don't require regular maintenance like manuring and watering. How is Miyawaki useful? The dense green cover of indigenous trees plays a key role in absorbing the dust particles of the area where the garden has been set up. The plants also help in regulating surface temperature. Some of the common indigenous plants that are used for these forests include Anjan, Amala, Bell, Arjun and Ganj. Source: 7 Champions of the Earth Award that recognizes outstanding environmental leaders from the public and private sectors was established by A. International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN. B. Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO. C. Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC. D. United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP. Solution: D. The United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP, established Champions of the Earth in 2005 as an annual awards program to recognize outstanding environmental leaders from the public and private sectors and from civil society. The Champions of the Earth Award is the UN's highest environmental honor. A. Consider the following statements. 1. Raptors are considered as apex predators, sitting at the top of the food chain. 2. Raptors act as an ecological barometer, helping in gauging the health of the environment. 3. Raptors provide valuable ecosystem services like controlling pest animals such as rodents and potentially reducing the spread of diseases. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution: C. Birds of prey or raptors are often apex predators, sitting at the top of the food chain. As such, they can act as an ecological barometer, helping us gauge the health of the environment. In addition to their value as indicator 14. Species. They provide valuable ecosystem services, controlling pest animals such as rodents and removing carrion from the environment, potentially reducing the spread of disease. 9. Consider the following statements regarding polar bears. 1. Polar bears are one of the most significant predators in the Arctic region and they keep biological populations in balance. 2. The Arctic sea ice is crucial to polar bear survival as they use it not only to hunt seals, but also for traveling, mating and resting. 3. Rising global temperatures can impact adult bears with deterioration and drop in its average weight. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1. 2. B. 1. 3. C. 2. 3. D. 1. 2. 3. Solution. D. The Arctic sea ice is crucial to polar bear survival as they use it not only to hunt seals, their chief food, but also for traveling, mating and resting. However, with rising global temperatures, the sea ice is breaking earlier in summer and refreezing later in winter, due to which polar bears get less time to hunt and have to stay hungry for longer and travel greater distances. This extra need for energy coupled with a lack of food can result in body deterioration and drop in the average weight of adult bears. Importance of polar bears. Polar bears are one of the most significant predators in the Arctic region and they keep biological populations in balance. The big is made by them serve as a food resource for scavengers like Arctic foxes and Arctic birds. If polar bears aren't able to hunt animals like seals, it can severely impact the food chain and health of the ecosystem. Researchers have also found that once polar bears can't find seals to eat, they would quickly move to kill and survive on other creatures in the Arctic region. This would threaten the existence of species like the Arctic fox or the walrus. Moreover, it might also cause the overpopulation of seals, which could endanger the existence of crustaceans and fish that are an important food source for local human populations as well as other Arctic wildlife. 3. Geography. 1. Consider the following statements regarding Foucault's pendulum. 1. Foucault's pendulum provides direct visual evidence that the Earth rotates on its axis. 2. Foucault's pendulum at the equator would not show any deviation from its original course. 3. It has been installed for the first time in the world in India's new Parliament building. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 3 is incorrect. 15. Suspended from the ceiling of the central foyer of India's new Parliament building, inaugurated on Sunday, May 29, is a Foucault pendulum that all but touches the floor as it rotates on its axis. The pendulum hangs from a skylight at the top of the Constitution Hall and signifies the integration of the idea of India with the idea of the cosmos. Created by the National Council of Science Museum, NCSM, in Kolkata, the pendulum is being dubbed as the largest such piece in India, 22 meters in height and weighing a staggering 36 kilograms. On the ground, a circular installation has been created to allow the pendulum's movement, with a short drill around it, allowing the visitors to stand around. At the latitude of the Parliament, it takes 49 hours, 59 minutes, and 18 seconds for the pendulum to complete one rotation, as per the details displayed at the installation. This Foucault pendulum is not something new. The first one was installed in 1991 at the University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, IUCAA, in Pune. What is the Foucault pendulum? The original Foucault pendulum, named after 19th century French scientist Léon Foucault, is a simple experiment to demonstrate the Earth's rotation. The experimental setup involves a heavy object hung from a height with a string, free to swing in any direction. Once set into and from motion, the pendulum is seen to change its orientation slowly over time. For example, if the initial motion imparted to it was in the north-south direction, after a few hours it could be seen moving in the east-west direction. Actually, it is not the pendulum that changes its plane of motion, but the ground beneath it. Observers standing on the ground do not notice the Earth's rotation, because they too are rotating with the Earth, but can notice the change in orientation of the pendulum. At the north and south poles, when the pendulum is aligned with the axis of rotation of the Earth, the pendulum's back and forth motion comes back to its original plane in exactly 24 hours. That is, if it starts swinging in the north-south direction, it then slowly turns in the northeast-southwest direction, then in the east-west direction. It keeps on changing its orientation, till it is back in its original orientation after 24 hours. At other latitudes, it takes longer for the pendulum to return to its original orientation of swinging. That is because the pendulum is not aligned with the axis of rotation of the Earth. At the equator, the pendulum is perpendicular to the axis of rotation, and hence it never changes its orientation of the swing. Meaning, a Foucault's pendulum at the equator would not show any deviation from its original course. At other latitudes it will, and would return to the original course after fixed time periods. Source. 16. 2. How are Himalayas different than Alps? 1. Most peaks in the Alps are not accessible compared to Himalayas. 2. High peaks of the Himalayas are significantly taller than the ones in the Alps. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution. B. Climbing in the Himalayas was fundamentally different than in the Alps. For 1, most peaks in the Alps are far more accessible than their Himalayan counterparts. This inaccessibility gave birth to expedition climbing. Climbing became military-like with massive logistics operations to support the actual ascent. Second, the high peaks of the Himalayas were also significantly taller than the ones in the Alps, posing multiple novel challenges, including thinning air at high altitudes. Source. 3. Consider the following statements. 1. Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world in terms of height above sea level. 2. Rombak Monastery is near the base of Mount Everest's northern side. 3. Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay completed the first confirmed ascent of Mount Everest. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay completed the first confirmed ascent of Mount Everest. Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world in terms of height above sea level. Rombak Monastery is near the base of Everest's northern side. Source. 4. Consider the following statements regarding graphene. 1. Graphene does not absorb or dissipate electromagnetic waves. 2. Graphene is highly sensitive to environmental changes, which makes it an excellent candidate for sensing chemical and biological agents. 3. US and Japan are global leaders in the commercial production of graphene. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 2 is correct. 17. Graphene has the potential to absorb and dissipate electromagnetic waves, making it valuable for developing stealth coatings and materials that reduce radar signatures and electromagnetic interference. Graphene is highly sensitive to environmental changes, which makes it an excellent candidate for sensing chemical biological agents, explosives, radiation, and other hazardous substances. Besides, graphene-based materials can also protect us against chemical and biological attacks. Better energy storage and electronics properties make graphene attractive in defense and aerospace as well as in civil and commercial applications. Among the leading countries in graphene research are China, the US, the UK, Japan, South Korea, Russia, and Singapore. Till 2012, graphene-related patent filing was dominated by the US from 2013 to 2016. South Korea and China matched the US after 2017. China surged ahead. In 2018, China filed 218 patents, while the other leading countries together filed 79. India had 8 filings. China and Brazil are global leaders in the commercial production of graphene. Source: 5. Consider the following statements regarding the onset of monsoon in India. 1. The onset of the monsoon marks a significant transition in the large-scale atmospheric and ocean circulations in the Indo-Pacific region. 2. The onset being the first rain of the season in India. 3. For determining the onset of monsoon, the India Meteorological Department (IMD) looks at the consistency of rainfall over a defined geography, the intensity of the rainfall, and the wind speed. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution: B. Statement 2 is incorrect. The onset of the monsoon over Kerala signals the beginning of the 4-month June-September southwest monsoon season, during which India gets more than 70% of its annual rainfall. It is an important day in the economic calendar of the country. Contrary to what is sometimes assumed, the onset does not mean the first rain of the season. That can start happening in certain places even before the onset is declared. For example, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands usually start receiving monsoon rainfall between May 15th and May 20th, and it starts raining along the Kerala coast in the last week of May. However, onset is a technical expression with a specific definition, and the IMD does not officially declare onset until certain prescribed conditions are met. What are these conditions which determine the onset of monsoon? According to the IMD, the onset of the monsoon happens when there is a significant transition in the large scale atmospheric and ocean circulations in the Indo-Pacific region. IMD announces the onset of the monsoon only after certain precisely defined and measurable parameters are met. The IMD essentially looks at the consistency of rainfall over a defined geography, the intensity of the rainfall, and the wind speed. Source: 6. Which of the following are conducive for the onset of the monsoon in India? 1. Westerly winds over the South Arabian Sea. 2. Increase in the depth of westerly winds up to middle tropospheric levels. 18. 3. Increase in cloudiness over areas covering the Southeast Arabian Sea, Lakshadweep, and Kerala coasts. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution: C. IMD says the conditions are becoming conducive for the onset of the monsoon. There are westerly winds over the South Arabian Sea and there is an increase in the depth of westerly winds up to middle tropospheric levels and an increase in cloudiness over areas covering the Southeast Arabian Sea, Lakshadweep, and Kerala coasts. Source: 7. Consider the following statements. 1. No cyclones in the Arabian Sea have formed during the onset phase of the Indian summer monsoon. 2. A weak onset of monsoon results in the formation of a cyclone. 3. About 90% of the very severe and super cyclones over the Arabian Sea strike during May, June, and November. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution: B. Statement 1 is incorrect. Some cyclones in the Arabian Sea have formed during the onset phase of the Indian summer monsoon. Such a situation arose in 1984, 1985, 1987, 1988, 1989, 1992, 1994, 1996, 1998, 2001, 2007, 2010, 2011, 2014, 2015, 2018, and 2019 between 1979 and 2019. This is 17 years out of 41, showed the paper. About 70% of tropical cyclones and 90% of the very severe and super cyclones over the Arabian Sea strike during May, June, and November. Cyclones and the monsoon impact each other. A cyclone cannot form if we have a strong monsoon. A weak onset of monsoon results in the formation of a cyclone. The reason for the weak onset is not clear. It could be El Nino, the warm phase of a recurring climate pattern across the tropical Pacific. Indian Ocean warming due to climate change could also be playing a role. Source: 8. Which of the following rules are followed by naming tropical cyclones? 1. The name should be neutral to politics and religious beliefs. 2. The name should not hurt the sentiments of any group of population over the globe. 3. The name should be short and easy to pronounce. 4. The maximum length of the name will be 6 letters. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. 19. Solution: C. Statement 4 is incorrect. Worldwide, there are 6 regional specialized meteorological centers, RSMCs, and 5 regional tropical cyclone warning centers, TCWCs, mandated for issuing advisories and naming of tropical cyclones. IMD is one of the 6 RSMCs to provide tropical cyclone and storm surge advisories to 13 member countries under the WMO, Economic and Social Commission for Asia Pacific, ESCAP panel including Bangladesh, India, Iran, Maldives, Myanmar, Oman, Pakistan, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, Sri Lanka, Thailand, United Arab Emirates, and Yemen. RSMC, New Delhi is also mandated to name the tropical cyclones developing over the North Indian Ocean, NIO, including the Bay of Bengal, BOB, and the Arabian Sea, AS. So, the tropical cycles forming over different ocean basins are named by the concerned RSMCs and TCWCs. Some rules are to be followed by naming cyclones, such as: asterisk, the proposed name should be neutral to politics and political figures; B. Religious beliefs; C. Cultures; and D. Gender. Name should be chosen in such a way that it does not hurt the sentiments of any group of population over the globe. It should not be very rude and cruel in nature. It should be short, easy to pronounce, and should not be offensive to any member. Asterisk, the maximum length of the name will be 8 letters. Source: 9. Consider the following statements. 1. The number of cyclones in the Arabian Sea is showing an increasing trend in the recent years. 2. Warm seas provide favorable conditions for the development and strengthening of cyclones. 3. June is one of the favorable months for the formation of cyclones in the Arabian Sea. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution: C. Is it not rare for cyclones to develop in the Arabian Sea? No, there are fewer number of cyclones in the Arabian Sea than the Bay of Bengal, but it is not uncommon. In fact, June is one of the favorable months for the formation of cyclones in the Arabian Sea. A cyclone is a low pressure system that forms over warm waters. Usually, a high temperature anywhere means the existence of low pressure air, and a low temperature means high pressure wind. In fact, that is one of the main reasons why we see greater number of cyclones in the Bay of Bengal compared to Arabian Sea. Bay of Bengal is slightly warmer. Because of climate change, the Arabian Sea side is also getting warmer, and as a result, the number of cyclones in the Arabian Sea is showing an increasing trend in the recent trend. As air warms over hotter regions, it ascends, leading to low pressure at the surface it is covering. When air cools in colder areas, it descends, leading to high pressure at the surface. In a depression or low pressure situation, the air is rising and blows in an anti-clockwise direction around the low in the northern hemisphere and in a clockwise direction in the southern hemisphere. This is because of the Coriolis effect, a result of the Earth's rotation on its axis. As warm air rises and cools, water vapor condenses to form clouds and thin lead rains. Weather systems formed over the Bay of Bengal in the peak of summer in May are among the strongest in the North Indian Ocean region. Warm seas present right conditions for development and strengthening of cyclones and fuel these systems over the water. 20. Source: 10. The Fujiwara effect is a geographical phenomenon that is associated with volcanic eruption. B. Continental drift. C. Tropical storms. D. Glaciation. Solution: C. The Fujiwara effect is any interaction between tropical storms around the same time in the same ocean region with their centers or rise at a distance of less than 1,400 km, with intensity that could vary between a depression, wind speed under 63 km per hour, and a super typhoon, wind speed over 209 km per hour. The interaction could lead to changes in the track and intensity of either or both storm systems. In rare cases, the two systems could merge, especially when they are of similar size and intensity, to form a bigger storm. 11. Consider the following statements regarding tropical cyclones. 1. Tropical cyclones develop when thunderstorm activity starts building close to the center of circulation. 2. The cyclone gets most of its energy from the latent heat released when water vapor that has evaporated from warm ocean waters condenses into liquid water. 3. Warm fronts or cold fronts are mainly associated with tropical cyclones. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution: B. Statement 3 is incorrect. Tropical cyclones are those which develop in the regions between the tropics of Capricorn and Cancer. They are the most devastating storms on Earth. Such cyclones develop when thunderstorm activity starts building close to the center of circulation, and the strongest winds and rain are no longer in a band far from the center. The core of the storm turns warm, and the cyclone gets most of its energy from the latent heat released when water vapor that has evaporated from warm ocean waters condenses into liquid water. Moreover, warm fronts or cold fronts are associated with tropical cyclones. Tropical cyclones have different names depending on their location and strength. For instance, they are known as hurricanes in the Caribbean Sea, the Gulf of Mexico, the North Atlantic Ocean, and the Eastern and Central North Pacific Ocean. In the Western North Pacific, they are called typhoons. Source: 12. Consider the following statements regarding the landfall of a cyclone. 1. A tropical cyclone is said to have made a landfall only when the center of the storm or its eye comes onshore. 2. The duration of the landfall depends on the speed of the winds and the size of the storm system. 3. Landfalls are often the most devastating moments of cyclones. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. 21. Solution B. Statement 1 is incorrect. Simply put, landfall is the event of a tropical cyclone coming onto land after being over water. As per the IMD, a tropical cyclone is said to have made a landfall when the center of the storm or its eye moves over the coast. Crucially, a landfall should not be confused with a direct hit, which refers to a situation where the core of high winds or eyewall comes onshore, but the center of the storm may remain offshore. As per the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration (NOAA), because the strongest winds in a tropical cyclone are not located precisely at the center, it is possible for a cyclone's strongest winds to be experienced over land even if landfall does not occur. The damage caused by the landfall will depend on the severity of the cyclone, marked by the speed of its winds. Landfalls can last for a few hours, with their exact duration depending on the speed of the winds and the size of the storm system. Cyclones lose their intensity once they move over land because of sharp reduction of moisture supply and increase in surface friction. This means that while landfalls are often the most devastating moments of cyclones, they also mark the beginning of its end. Source. 13. Consider the following statements. 1. Unlike many other natural hazards, cyclones give adequate warning of their arrival. 2. Cyclones lose their energy very quickly once they cross over to land. 3. Longer landfall of a cyclone has a great potential to cause destruction. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. Unlike many other natural hazards, cyclones give adequate warning of their arrival. In the Indian context, it takes them between 4 and 5 days to reach the landmass from the North Indian Ocean, both on the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal sides. If a sufficient number of weather instruments are monitoring them, from the oceans as well as from satellites, everything about the cyclones, speed, intensity, trajectory, associated wind speeds can be predicted accurately. Longer landfalls have a greater potential to cause destruction. The most dramatic landfall was in the case of the Odisha supercyclone of 1998, the most devastating cyclone to have hit India in recent decades. That process had continued for nearly 30 hours. Usually, cyclones lose their energy very quickly once they cross over to land. In a way, every cyclone is unique. No two cyclones have the same characteristics. Source. 22. 14. Brahmaputra River is often flooded in India, but not in Tibet. What could be the possible reasons for it? 1. In Tibet, the river carries a smaller volume of water and less silt as it is a cold and dry area. 2. Unlike other North Indian rivers, Brahmaputra is marked by huge deposits of silt on its bed, causing the riverbed to rise. Select the correct answer code. A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution C. In Tibet, the river carries a smaller volume of water and less silt as it is a cold and dry area. In India, it passes through a region of high rainfall. Here, the river carries a large volume of water and considerable amount of silt. Every year during the rainy season, the river overflows its banks, causing widespread devastation due to floods in Assam and Bangladesh. Unlike other North Indian rivers, the Brahmaputra is marked by huge deposits of silt on its bed, causing the riverbed to rise. The river also shifts its channel frequently. 15. Consider the following statements. 1. Volcanoes occur only when tectonic plates either move away from each other or when one pushes beneath another. 2. Mantle is not made of uniform rock, and differences in the type of mantle rock make it melt at different temperatures. 3. Both oceanic magma and continental magma have same chemical composition, but vary in exclusion depending on magma chambers. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution A. Only statement 2 is correct. Earth's crust is made up of tectonic plates that are slowly moving at about the same speed as fingernail grows. Volcanoes typically occur where these plates either move away from each other or where one pushes beneath another. But volcanoes can also be in the middle of plates, as Hawaii's volcanoes are in the Pacific plate. The crust and mantle that comprise the Pacific plate cracks at different places as it moves northwestward. Beneath Hawaii, magma can move upward through the cracks to feed different volcanoes on the surface. The same thing happens at Helicala, on Maui, which last erupted about 250 years ago. Scientists hypothesize that the mantle is not made of uniform rock. Instead, differences in the type of mantle rock make it melt at different temperatures. Mantle rock is solid at some places, while it starts to melt at other places. Hawaii is in the middle of an oceanic plate. In fact, it is the most isolated volcanic hotspot on Earth, far away from any plate boundary. Oceanic magma is very different from continental magma. It has a different chemical composition and flows much more easily. So, the magma is less prone to volcanic vents on its ascent, which would ultimately lead to more explosive volcanism. 23. 16. Consider the following statements regarding Indian Ocean Dipole (IOD). 1. Indian Ocean Dipole (IOD) is said to be negative when the western side of the Indian Ocean, near the Somalia coast, becomes warmer than the eastern Indian Ocean. 2. A positive IOD event is often seen developing at times of El Nino, while a negative IOD is sometimes associated with La Nina. 3. A positive IOD helps rainfall along the African coastline and also over the Indian subcontinent while suppressing rainfall over Indonesia, Southeast Asia and Australia. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 1 is incorrect. IOD, sometimes referred to as the Indian Nino, is a similar phenomenon playing out in the relatively smaller area of the Indian Ocean between the Indonesian and Malaysian coastline in the east and the African coastline near Somalia in the west. One side of the ocean, along the equator, gets warmer than the other. IOD is said to be positive when the western side of the Indian Ocean, near the Somalia coast, becomes warmer than the eastern Indian Ocean. It is negative when the western Indian Ocean is cooler. A positive IOD event is often seen developing at times of El Nino, while a negative IOD is sometimes associated with La Nina. During El Nino, the Pacific side of Indonesia is cooler than normal because of which the Indian Ocean side also gets cooler. That helps the development of a positive IOD. A positive IOD helps rainfall along the African coastline and also over the Indian subcontinent while suppressing rainfall over Indonesia, Southeast Asia and Australia. The impacts are opposite during a negative IOD event. Source. 17. Volcanic activity is monitored through which of the following methods or instruments? 1. Chemical analysis of gases coming out through fumaroles. 2. Global positioning system, GPS. 3. Tiltmeters. 4. Seismometers. How many of the above options are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution D. Volcanic activity is monitored by many different instruments. The perhaps simplest to understand is GPS. The way scientists use GPS is different from that of everyday life. It can detect minuscule movements of a few centimeters. On volcanoes, any upward movement on the surface detected by GPS indicates that something is pushing from underneath. Even more sensitive are tiltmeters, which are in essence the same as bubble levels that people use to hang pictures on a wall. Any change in the tilt on a volcano slope indicates that the volcano is breathing, again because of magma moving below. 24. Volcanoes like Hawaii are monitored with a large network of seismographs. Any movement of magma below will cause tremors that are picked up by the seismometers. Other ways that volcanic activity is monitored include chemical analysis of gases coming out through fumaroles, holes or cracks through which volcanic gases escape. 4. Government schemes and programs. 1. India has been issuing commemorative coins since the 1960s for which of the following reasons? 1. Paying homage to notable personalities. 2. Spreading awareness about government schemes. 3. Remembering key historic events. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. India has been issuing commemorative coins since the 1960s for several reasons, such as paying homage to notable personalities, spreading awareness about government schemes, or remembering key historic events. Source. 2. India's existing strategic coin storage facilities that are made up of excavated rock caverns are located at 1. Mangaluru in Karnataka. 2. Padur in Telangana. 3. Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh. How many of the above options are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. The country's three existing strategic coin storage facilities at Mangaluru and Padur in Karnataka and Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh are made up of excavated rock caverns. Source. 3. Consider the following statements regarding the concept of adverse possession. 1. Adverse possession refers to the hostile possession of property, which must be continuous, uninterrupted, and peaceful. 2. The concept of adverse possession stems from the idea that land must not be left vacant but instead be put to judicious use. 3. Under the Limitation Act, 1963, any person in possession of private land for over 12 years or government land for over 30 years can become the owner of that property. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 125. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. There is no justification for introducing any change in the law relating to adverse possession, the 22nd Law Commission has said in its recent report. What is adverse possession? The concept of adverse possession stems from the idea that land must not be left vacant but instead be put to judicious use. Essentially, adverse possession refers to the hostile possession of property, which must be continuous, uninterrupted, and peaceful. What provisions did the Limitation Act 1963 bring with it? The 1963 Act fortified the position of the true owner of the land, as he now had to merely prove his title, while the burden of proof of adverse possession shifted to the person claiming it. Under the Limitation Act 1963, any person in possession of private land for over 12 years or government land for over 30 years can become the owner of that property, as laid down in Article 64, 65, 111, or 112 of the 1963 Act relating to suits for possession of immovable property. Source. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. Genetic Engineering Appraisal Committee, GEAC, is the apex technical body charged with evaluating proposals for testing genetically modified GMCs in India. 2. Genetic Engineering Appraisal Committee, GEAC, functions under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. 3. At present, cotton and mustard remains the only two transgenic crops that are being commercially cultivated in India. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution A. Only statement 1 is correct. There is an array of crops, brinjal, tomato, maize, chickpea, in various stages of trials that employ transgenic technology. However, cotton remains the only transgenic crop that is being commercially cultivated in India. After a long hiatus, the GEAC, the apex technical body charged with evaluating proposals for testing genetically modified GM seeds, approved the environmental release of mustard hybrid DMH11 and its parental lines during its 147th meeting on the 18th of October 2022 for seed production and testing. This is one step away from full commercial cultivation. GEAC is under the Union Environment Ministry. Source. 5. Consider the following statements regarding mandatory minimum sentencing. 1. Mandatory minimum sentencing means a quantum of punishment which cannot be reduced below the period fixed. 26. 2. In India, such sentences are prescribed for sexual offences under the Prevention of Children from Sexual Offences, POCSO Act. 3. When the legislature has prescribed a minimum sentence without discretion, the same can be reduced by the courts. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 3 is incorrect. The concept of mandatory minimum sentencing refers to a sentence which must be imposed without leaving any discretion to the court. It means a quantum of punishment which cannot be reduced below the period fixed. The apex court held in its 2016 ruling in Muhammad Hashim v. State of UP and others. Essentially, this predetermines the minimum punishment or sentence for certain offences which are considered to be more serious than others, with a view to ensure justice and not let the perpetrator of such an offence go unpunished. No matter what the unique individual circumstances of the offender or the offence might be, the court must mandatorily award the minimum period of sentencing for the offences which prescribe it. A concept that comes primarily from the Canadian and American legal systems. In India, such sentences are prescribed for all sexual offences under the Prevention of Children from Sexual Offences, POCSO Act, except the offence of sexual harassment. Under Section 8 of the POCSO Act, a punishment of 3 to 5 years has been prescribed for offences under Section 7 which deals with offences of sexual assault against children. However, imposing the minimum punishment in such cases is mandatory. When the legislature has prescribed a minimum sentence without discretion, the same cannot be reduced by the courts. 6. Consider the following statements regarding National Family Health Survey, NFHS. 1. National Family Health Survey, NFHS, started in 1990s, is conducted in a representative sample of households. 2. It is conducted annually throughout India. 3. The primary focus of NFHS is maternal and child health. 4. The NFHS is the only survey that the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare conducts. How many of the above options are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution B. Statement 1 and 3 are correct. The NFHS is a large survey conducted in a representative sample of households throughout India which started in 1992-93 and is repeated at an interval of about 4 to 5 years. It is the Indian version of the Demographic and Health Service, DHS, as it is known in other countries. 27. The primary focus of NFHS is maternal and child health, the Department of Health and Family Welfare Statistics Division said. The NFHS is not the only survey that the Health Ministry conducts. In the last 5 years, it has conducted the National NCD Monitoring Survey, NMS, the National Mental Health Survey, NMHS, the Global Adult Tobacco Survey, GATS, the Alcohol Survey, the Comprehensive National Nutrition Survey, CNNS, and many others. Source. 7. Consider the following statements. 1. Universal Immunization Program, UIP, covers children up to 16 years of age. 2. A country is declared measles rubella, Mr. eliminated if there is zero transmission of measles and rubella viruses, evidenced by zero clinical disease, sustained over 3 years. 3. The measles rubella virus is transmitted only in children and does not get transmitted in adolescents. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution A. Only statement 2 is correct. Universal Childhood Immunization Program, UIP, covers only those up to 5 years. Mr. Elimination is defined as zero transmission of measles and rubella viruses, evidenced by zero clinical disease, sustained over 3 years. The rubella virus is a slower transmitter and the risk of rubella is extended from childhood through adolescence into the reproductive age range. A. Consider the following statements. 1. Under old pension scheme OPS, the contribution of the current generation of workers was explicitly used to pay the pensions of existing pensioners. 2. National Pension Scheme NPS is a contributory pension scheme under which employees contribute 14% of their salary. 3. NPS is mandatory for central government employees joining services on or after January 1, 2004. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 2 is incorrect. An old pension scheme OPS, commonly known as the PAYG scheme, is defined as an unfunded pension scheme where current revenues fund pension benefits. Under the scheme, the contribution of the current generation of workers was explicitly used to pay the pensions of existing pensioners. OPS involved a direct transfer of resources from the current generation of taxpayers to fund the pensioners. NPS is a defined contribution pension scheme. NPS enables an individual to undertake retirement planning by employment with systematic savings and investments. 28. NPS facilitates the accumulation of pension corpus during their working life. NPS is designed to deliver a sustainable solution of having adequate retirement income in old age or upon superannuation. The current national pension scheme requires employees to contribute 10% of their basic salary in pay. Government 14%. The eventual payout depends on the market returns on that corpus, which is mostly invested in federal debt. In contrast, the old pension scheme OPS guarantees a fixed pension of 50% of an employee's last drawn salary without requiring them to contribute anything during their working life. NPS is mandatory for central government employees joining services on or after January 1, 2004, and almost all state governments have adopted it for their employees. NPS is regulated by the Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority, PFRDA. Source. 9. Consider the following statements regarding National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, NCPCR. 1. The National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, NCPCR, is a non-statutory body that works under the administrative control of the Ministry of Law and Justice. 2. The Commission's mandate is to ensure that all laws, policies, programs, and administrative mechanisms are in consonance with the child rights perspective as enshrined in the Constitution of India. 3. It examines all factors that inhibit the enjoyment of rights of children affected by terrorism, communal violence, natural disaster, and domestic violence and recommend appropriate remedial measures. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 1 is incorrect. About NCPCR. Set up in March 2007 under the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act 2005. It works under the administrative control of the Ministry of Women and Child Development. The Commission's mandate is to ensure that all laws, policies, programs, and administrative mechanisms are in consonance with the child rights perspective as enshrined in the Constitution of India and also the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child. The Commission shall perform all or any of the following functions, namely: examine and review the safeguards provided by or under any law for the time being in force for the protection of child rights and recommend measures for their effective implementation. Present to the central government, annually and at such other intervals, if the commission may deem fit, reports upon working of those safeguards. Inquire into violation of child rights and recommend initiation of proceedings in such cases. Examine all factors that inhibit the enjoyment of rights of children affected by terrorism, communal violence, riots, natural disaster, domestic violence, HIV, AIDS, trafficking, maltreatment, torture and exploitation, pornography and prostitution and recommend appropriate remedial measures. 10. Consider the following statements regarding PM Gati Shakti. 1. PM Gati Shakti aims to institutionalize holistic planning for major infrastructure projects. 2. It is intended to break departmental silos and connect different ministries for the execution of infrastructure projects. 3. The Gati Shakti portal's data is restricted to central and state government agencies and departments. 29. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. PM Gati Shakti, National Master Plan for Infrastructure Development aimed at boosting multimodal connectivity and driving down logistics costs. PM Gati Shakti aims to institutionalize holistic planning for major infrastructure projects. PM Gate City is a digital platform that connects different ministries, including roads and highways, railways, shipping, petroleum and gas, power, telecom, shipping, and aviation, with a view to ensuring holistic planning and execution of infrastructure projects. So far, access to portal's data, which include detailed maps of existing economic and social infrastructure as well as upcoming projects, is restricted to central and state government agencies and departments. Source. 11. Consider the following statements regarding Pradhan Mantri Poshan Shakti Nirman PM Poshan. 1. The scheme provides one hot cook meal in government and government aided schools. 2. The scheme is being implemented by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. 3. The scheme is implemented only in areas which are poor in nutritional status. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution A. Only statement 1 is correct. Centrally sponsored scheme, Pradhan Mantri Poshan Shakti Nirman PM Poshan for providing one hot cook meal in government and government aided schools from 2021-22 to 2025-26. The scheme is being implemented by the Ministry of Education. Under the scheme, there is provision of hot cook meal to children of preschools of Balbatika before class 1 in primary schools also in addition to the 11.80 children of classes I to 8 studying in 11.20 schools. The scheme is implemented across the country covering all the eligible children without any discrimination of gender and social class. The main objectives of the PM Poshan scheme, earlier known as mid-day meal scheme, are to address two of the pressing problems for majority of children in India, with hunger and education by improving the nutritional status of eligible children in government and government aided schools as well as encouraging poor children belonging to disadvantaged sections to attend school more regularly and help them concentrate on classroom activities. 30. 5. Science and technology. 1. Consider the following statements regarding polygraph tests. 1. Rather than injecting drugs into the body, polygraph tests measure pulse rate, respiration, change in sweat gland activity and blood flow of the accused. 2. The Supreme Court has held that no lie detector test should be administered except on the basis of consent of the accused. 3. National Human Rights Commission has provided guidelines for the administration of polygraph tests on an accused. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. A polygraph test is carried out on the assumption that physiological responses triggered when one is lying are different from what they otherwise would be. Rather than injecting drugs into the body, polygraph tests attach instruments like cardiographs or sensitive electrodes to the suspect and measure variables such as blood pressure, pulse rate, respiration, change in sweat gland activity, blood flow, etc., while the suspect is being questioned. In the 2010 Supreme Court ruling in Selvi and Osby Estate of Karnataka, in AR 2010, a bench of the then Chief Justice of India K.T. Balakrishnan and Justices R.V. Ravindran and J.M. Panchal held that no lie detector test should be administered except on the basis of consent of the accused. Those who volunteer must have access to a lawyer and have the physical, emotional, and legal implications of the test explained to them by the police and the lawyer. The court emphasized that the guidelines for the administration of polygraph tests on an accused, published by the National Human Rights Commission in 2000, must be strictly followed. Source. 2. Consider the following statements. 1. CPUs, central processing units, and GPUs, graphics processing units, perform multiple operations simultaneously using parallel processing techniques. 2. Floating point operations per second, FLOPS, is a commonly used metric to measure the computational performance in the field of high-performance computing, HPC, and artificial intelligence, AI. 3. Memory bandwidth, latency, and architectural features play significant role in a computer's performance. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. FLOPS, or floating point operations per second, is a commonly used metric to measure the computational performance, processing power, and efficiency, especially in the field of high-performance computing, HPC. And artificial intelligence, AI. Floating point operations are a certain kind of mathematical calculation using real numbers with fractional parts. 31. Modern computing systems, such as CPUs, central processing units, and GPUs, graphics processing units, are designed to perform multiple operations simultaneously using parallel processing techniques. What is the beta flop? Due to the immense computing power of today's computers, the FLOPS metric is most often represented in terms of billions, giga, trillions, tera, or even quadrillions, peta, of operations per second, DFLOPs, TFLOPs, PFLOPs, respectively. A beta flop is thus equal to 1000 TFLOPs or 1015 FLOPs. Are FLOPs the only metric to judge a computer's performance? No, FLOPs is not the only factor determining the performance of a computing system. Memory bandwidth, latency, and other architectural features also play significant roles. Nonetheless, FLOPs provide a valuable baseline for comparing the computational capabilities of different systems, especially in tasks where floating point calculations dominate. Source. 3. Consider the following statements regarding measles. 1. Measles is a highly contagious bacterial disease which affects mostly children. 2. Measles spreads by coughing and sneezing, close personal contact or direct contact with infected nasal or throat secretions. 3. There is no specific treatment for measles, but there is a vaccine to stay protected from the disease. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. Statement 1 is incorrect. Measles, or as it is called, Kaswe, is a highly contagious viral disease which affects mostly children. It is one of the leading causes of death and disability among young children. There is no specific treatment for measles, but there is a vaccine to stay protected from the disease, which is both safe as well as cost effective. Measles spreads by coughing and sneezing, close personal contact or direct contact with infected nasal or throat secretions. So, isolation of these infected children is essential. Death due to measles are caused by the complications associated with the disease like blindness, encephalitis, severe diarrhea, and pneumonia. The condition of an infected child turns severe in cases of poor nourishment, vitamin A deficiency, and if the child is immunocompromised. 4. Consider the following statements. 1. The physical temperature of an object determines the wavelength of the radiation it emits. 2. The hotter the object, the longer the wavelength of peak emission. 3. X-rays come from pulsars, galactic supernova remnants, and black holes. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution B. 32. Statement 2 is incorrect. The physical temperature of an object determines the wavelength of the radiation it emits. The hotter the object, the shorter the wavelength of peak emission. X-rays come from objects that are millions of degrees Celsius, such as pulsars, galactic supernova remnants, and black holes. Source. 5. Consider the following statements. 1. The weight of an aircraft does not have any impact on its takeoff and landing speed. 2. The maximum weight an aircraft can carry is impacted by the length of the runway. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. Solution B. The weight of an aircraft is a crucial component that governs the choices the pilot has to make while operating the flight. The pilot has to intricately balance the weight of passengers, baggage, and fuel to ensure that the aircraft is not overloaded. If an aircraft is overloaded, it would need a higher takeoff and landing speed, which in turn calls for a longer takeoff, run, and landing roll. It would also reduce the maneuverability of the aircraft and place excess pressure on landing gear, resulting in wear and tear. The maximum weight an aircraft can carry is also significantly impacted by the length of the runway, the departure and arrival airports, and whether there is wet grass or water on the runway. Source. 6. Consider the following statements. 1. Superbugs are bacteria that are resistant to several types of antibiotics. 2. Acinetobacter baumannii is a bacterium that can cause pneumonia, meningitis, and infect wounds. 3. Antibiotic resistance occurs when bacteria changes its response to the use of antibiotics. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. Superbugs are bacteria that are resistant to several types of antibiotics. What is Acinetobacter baumannii? In 2017, the bacterium was identified by the World Health Organization, WHO, as one of the world's most dangerous antibiotic-resistant bacteria. Notoriously difficult to eradicate, a baumannii can cause pneumonia, meningitis, and infect wounds, all of which can lead to death. A baumannii is usually found in hospital settings, where it can survive on surfaces for long periods. The WHO list of superbugs highlighted bacteria that are having built-in abilities to find new ways to resist treatment and can pass along genetic material that allows other bacteria to become drug-resistant as well. 33. How do bacteria become resistant to drugs? Antibiotics are medicines used to prevent and treat bacterial infections. Antibiotic resistance occurs when bacteria change in response to the use of these medicines, says the WHO. This ultimately threatens the ability of medicines to treat common infectious diseases. Source. 7. Consider the following statements regarding chikungunya. 1. Chikungunya was first discovered in Tanzania in the 1950s. 2. Tropical regions currently see the highest rates of chikungunya virus. 3. Asian tiger mosquito also transmits the chikungunya virus. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution C. First discovered in Tanzania in the 1950s, the viral disease has since spread to various parts of Africa, Asia, the Caribbean, and South America. Tropical regions currently see the highest rates of the virus, with Paraguay, Brazil, Bolivia, and Thailand most affected. However, climate change is driving disease carrying mosquitoes closer to the poles. The Asian tiger mosquito, which transmits the virus, is spreading more and more. This mosquito species is already native to southern Europe, and it is becoming increasingly common in Germany. Source. A. Consider the following statements regarding computer-generated imagery, CGI technology. 1. It is the process of creating and manipulating images that do not exist in the physical environment. 2. The images can be either static or dynamic and are utilized in both 2D and 3D movies. 3. It can be used to generate specific elements of a scene, or even a substantial portion of an entire sequence. 4. The Bahubali series is a notable example that extensively employs CGI technology. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution. D. Computer-generated imagery, CGI. In basic terms, computer-generated imagery, or CGI, refers to the utilization of computers to create pictures or characters in film and television. It can also be defined as the process of creating and manipulating images that do not exist in the physical environment for being captured on film or video. These images can be either static or dynamic and are utilized in both 2D and 3D movies. Due to its increased affordability compared to the past, CGI is now extensively used to generate specific elements of a short or a scene, or even a substantial portion of an entire sequence. S.S. Rajamouli's Eagle and the Bahubali series, S. Shankar's Jeans, Enthiran, and 2.0, and Anubhav Sinha's Raman are notable examples of Indian movies that extensively employ CGI. 34. Source. 9. Consider the following statements. 1. Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, CERT, functions under the Ministry of Home Affairs. 2. Internet Protocol Address, IP Address, helps law enforcement agencies track down individual users and their accurate location. 3. A virtual private network, VPN, creates several proxy identities for users' data and delivers it safely without disturbing the content of the data. How many of the above options are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 1 is incorrect. Indian Computer Emergency Response Team or CERT, aware of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. What is a VPN and how do these networks function? Any and all devices connected to the internet are part of a large network of computers, servers and other devices spread across the world. To identify each device connected to the internet, service providers globally assign a unique address to each device called the Internet Protocol Address or IP Address. It is this IP address that helps websites, law enforcement agencies and even companies track down individual users and their accurate location. A virtual private network, when switched on, essentially creates a safe network within the larger global network of the internet and masks the IP address of the user by rerouting the data. Acting as a tunnel, a VPN takes data originating from one server and masks it in a different identity before delivering it to the destination server. In essence, a VPN creates several proxy identities for your data and delivers it safely without disturbing the content of the data. 10. Consider the following statements. 1. Ethnoveterinary medicine, EVM, involves the use of antibiotics in treating diseases of cattle. 2. Antimicrobial resistance, AMRA, accelerates due to the misuse and overuse of antimicrobials in human health, animal health, aquaculture and crop production. 3. Waste from farms, factories, community and healthcare settings contributes to the emergence and spread of antimicrobial resistance through environmental routes. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 1 is incorrect. Ethnoveterinary medicine, EVM, involves the use of traditional herbal preparations in treating diseases of cattle. 35. Antimicrobial resistance, AMRA, is a one health issue. It accelerates due to the misuse and overuse of antimicrobials in human health, animal health, food animal production, aquaculture and crop production. Waste from farms, factories, community and healthcare settings contributes to the emergence and spread of AMRA through environmental routes. Prevention implies the addition of strategies and approaches that can reduce the need for antimicrobials. For example, in human health sector, better sanitation, access to clean water and appropriate hand hygiene can reduce chances of infection and need for antimicrobials. Similarly, better biosecurity, timely vaccinations, use of alternatives and appropriate waste management can prevent infectious diseases in food animal production systems. 11. Consider the following statements regarding lab-grown diamonds. 1. Lab-grown diamonds are produced by a manufacturing process that mimics the natural conditions of diamond formation. 2. They consist of actual carbon atoms arranged in the natural diamond crystal structure. 3. They exhibit different optical and chemical properties when compared to natural diamonds. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 3 is incorrect. Lab-grown diamonds, also known as lab-created diamonds, man-made diamonds, engineered diamonds, and cultured diamonds, are grown in highly controlled laboratory environments using advanced technological processes that duplicate the conditions under which diamonds naturally develop when they form in the mantle beneath the earth's crust. These lab-created diamonds consist of actual carbon atoms arranged in the characteristic diamond crystal structure. Since they are made of the same material as natural diamonds, they exhibit the same optical and chemical properties. It is important to note the major distinction between lab-grown diamonds and diamond simulants. Diamond simulants look similar to diamonds but are not true carbon crystals. Simulants do not have the same chemical and physical properties as natural diamonds and therefore sell at much lower prices than lab-created diamonds. Simulants can be distinguished from natural or lab-created diamonds using only the naked eye. 12. The application of somatic cell nuclear transfer technology is the manufacture of biodegradable plastics. B. Reproductive cloning of animals. C. Production of biolarvicides. D. Production of organisms free of disease solution. B. In genetics and developmental biology, somatic cell nuclear transfer, SCNT, is a laboratory strategy for creating a viable embryo from a body cell and an egg cell. The technique consists of taking an enucleated oocyte, egg cell, and implanting a donor nucleus from a somatic body cell. It is used in both therapeutic and reproductive cloning. 36. 6. International relations and organizations. 1. Which of the following is are the specialized agencies of the United Nations? 1. International Telecommunication Union. 2. International Fund for Agricultural Development. 3. International Monetary Fund. 4. World Meteorological Organization. 5. World Tourism Organization. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 2. B. Only 3. C. Only 4. D. All of the above. Solution. D. Specialized agencies of FAO. FAO. Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations. ICAO, International Civil Aviation Organization. IFAD, International Fund for Agricultural Development. ILO, International Labour Organization. IMF, International Monetary Fund. IMO, International Maritime Organization. ITU, International Telecommunication Union. UNESCO, United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. UNIDO, United Nations Industrial Development Organization. UNWTO, World Tourism Organization. UPU, Universal Postal Union. WHO, World Health Organization. WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization. WMO, World Meteorological Organization. World Bank Group. IBRD, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. IDA, International Development Association. IFC, International Finance Corporation. 2. Consider the following statements regarding North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO. 1. NATO is an intergovernmental military alliance that constitutes a system of collective defense. 2. It was established in the aftermath of World War II. 3. The accession of new members to NATO require unanimous approval by all current members. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. NATO is an intergovernmental military alliance of 31 European and North American countries that constitutes a system of collective defense. The accession process is overseen by the North Atlantic Council, NATO's governing body. Established in the aftermath of World War II, the organization implemented the North Atlantic Treaty, signed in Washington, D.C. on the 4th of April 1949. NATO was formed with 12 founding members. 37. Membership has subsequently grown to 31 through several enlargements, which require unanimous approval by all current members. Source. 3. The dispute over the sharing of water from the Helmand River is between Egypt and Ethiopia. B. Laos and Thailand. C. Iran and Afghanistan. D. Kyrgyzstan and Tajikistan. Solution. C. Iran and Afghanistan are locked in a long-standing dispute over the sharing of water from the Helmand River. The Helmand is Afghanistan's longest river. It originates near Kabul in the western Hindu Kush mountain range and flows in a southwesterly direction through desert areas for a total of about 1,150 kilometers, 750 miles, before emptying into Lake Hammam, which straddles the Afghanistan-Iran border. Lake Hammam is the largest freshwater lake in Iran. Source. 4. Tiananmen Square, recently seen in news, is located in South Korea. B. Japan. C. China. D. Bhutan. Solution. C. Tiananmen Square is a city square in the city center of Beijing, China. It has great cultural significance as it was the site of several important events in Chinese history. Outside China, the square is best known for the 1989 protests and massacre that ended with a military crackdown, which is also known as the Tiananmen Square Massacre or the June 4th Massacre. Source. 5. Consider the following statements regarding OPEC+. 1. OPEC+ is a grouping of OPEC countries and allied major oil-producing countries. 38. 2. Russia was recently removed from the grouping. 3. The objective of the organization is to unify the petroleum policies of its member countries and ensure the stabilization of oil markets in order to secure regular supply of petroleum to consumers. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 2 is incorrect. What is OPEC Plus? Established in 1960 by founding members Iran, Iraq, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, and Venezuela, OPEC has since expanded and now has 13 member states. With the addition of another 10 allied major oil-producing countries that include Russia, the grouping is known as OPEC Plus. The objective of the organization is to coordinate and unify the petroleum policies of its member countries and ensure the stabilization of oil markets in order to secure an efficient, economic and regular supply of petroleum to consumers, a steady income to producers and a fair return on capital for those investing in the petroleum industry. Source. 6. Consider the following statements. 1. Indian women received universal suffrage during India's independence. 2. India has ratified Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, CEDAW. 3. India became the first country to deploy an all-women contingent to a UN peacekeeping mission. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. Indian women received universal suffrage during India's independence in 1947. During the drafting of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, India was instrumental in ensuring that gender-sensitive norms were respected by changing the language from "all men are created equal" to "all human beings are". India has also ratified key international conventions to end discrimination against women, which include the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, CEDAW. India has been sending women personnel on UN peacekeeping missions. In 2007, India became the first country to deploy an all-women contingent to a UN peacekeeping mission. 7. Banjul formula is related to. A. G20 Forum. B. ASEAN. C. African Union, AU. D. BIMSTEC. Solution. C. 39. India-Africa Summit started from 2008 with New Delhi as its first venue. Since then, it was decided to hold these summits every 3 years, alternately in India and Africa. Second summit was held in Addis Ababa in 2011. The third summit, scheduled to be held in 2014, was postponed because of the Ebola outbreak and took place in October 2015. For the first time, the India-Africa Summit has done away with the so-called Banjul formula. This summit was important because it dispensed with the practice of following the Banjul formula. This Banjul formula was adopted by the African Union in 2006 and it meant that India would invite only 15 heads of state or government through the African Union. But this time, all the 54 heads of state and government were invited and of all who came, 40 were heads of state. Source. A. Consider the following statements. 1. The Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, is a grouping of high-income democratic countries. 2. Gulf Cooperation Council, GCC, countries is a grouping of 8 Arab nations located around the Arabian Gulf. 3. At present, more than 50% of India's remittances are from the high-tech Indian migrants in the US, United Kingdom, and Singapore. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 1 is correct. Slower growth in OECD economies, especially in the high-tech sector in the United States that could affect the demand for information technology, if workers and lead to a diversion of formal remittances toward informal money transfer channels, is likely to impact the flow of remittances this year. India, which registered a growth of more than 24% to reach a record high $111 billion in remittances in 2022, is expected to post a growth of just 0.2% in remittance flows in 2023, according to the World Bank's latest Migration and Development Brief. The Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, is a grouping of 38 high-income democratic countries. A lower demand for migrants in the Gulf Cooperation Council, GCC, countries, a grouping. Of 6 Arab nations located around the Arabian Gulf where declining oil prices have dented growth, is another key contributing factor. What are the top sources of remittances for India? Almost 36% of India's remittances are from the high-skilled and largely high-tech Indian migrants in three high-income destinations, the US, United Kingdom, and Singapore. Source. 9. Both India and United States are party to which of the following? 1. Quadrilateral Security Dialogue. 2. I2U2 Grouping. 3. CHIP4 Alliance. How many of the above options are correct? A. Only 140B, only 2C, all 3D, none. Solution. B. Quadrilateral Security Dialogue gained strategic heft after the 4-country grouping, which is Australia and Japan alongside India and the US, was repurposed in 2017, primarily as a counter to China's growing influence in the Indian Ocean Rim and as a forum for redoubling focus on the Indo-Pacific region. The I2U2, a grouping of India, Israel, the US and the United Arab Emirates, is focused on joint investments and new initiatives in water, energy, transportation, space, health, and food security. The US is already pursuing the CHIP4 Alliance initiative with 3 other top semiconductor makers, Taiwan, Japan, and South Korea. Source. 10. Hiroshima AI process, HAP, that was recently seen in news as the initiative of A. G20 grouping. B. OECD. C. ASEAN. D. G7 grouping. Solution. D. The annual group of 7 G7 summit, hosted by Japan, took place in Hiroshima on May 19, 2021-2023. Among other matters, the G7 Hiroshima leaders community initiated the Hiroshima AI process, HAP, an effort by this bloc to determine a way forward to regulate artificial intelligence AI. Source. 11. Bangkok Vision 2030, recently seen in news as related to. A. Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ASEAN. B. East Asia Summit, ACAS. C. Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation, BIMSTEC. D. Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO. Solution. C. The Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation, BIMSTEC Summit, end of. This year we'll adopt a Bangkok Vision 2030, which would be a watching kind of document and give direction to the organization. Thailand has put forth the Bangkok Vision 2030, which seeks to propel the IMSCTC towards a region that is prosperous, resilient and open, moving us in a forward-looking trajectory for sustainable and balanced growth. The grouping comprises Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Myanmar, Nepal, Sri Lanka and Thailand. In 2022, the BIMSTEC Charter was adopted, which lays the foundation for it to function as a full-fledged organization. Source. 12. Consider the following statements regarding Artemis Accords. 1. The Artemis Accords is a binding multilateral arrangement between the United States government and other world governments participating in the Artemis program. 41. 2. The Accords establish a framework for cooperation in the exploration and peaceful use of the Moon, Mars and other astronomical objects. 3. India was amongst the earliest countries to sign the Accords. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 2 is correct. The Artemis Accords is a non-binding multilateral arrangement between the United States government and other world governments participating in the Artemis program. As of June 23, 2023, 27 countries and 1 territory have signed the Accords, including 10 in Europe, 8 in Asia, 3 in North America, 2 in Oceania, 2 in Africa, and 2 in South America. Drafted by NASA and the US Department of State, the Accords establish a framework for cooperation in the civil exploration and peaceful use of the Moon, Mars, and other astronomical objects. Latest Accords were signed between India and USA on the 22nd of June 2023. Source. 13. Consider the following statements regarding Quad Quadrilateral Security Dialogue. 1. Quad has a humanitarian assistance and disaster relief (HADR) partnership to coordinate their disaster response operations in the Indo-Pacific region. 2. The Secretariat of Quad is based in the United States. 3. Regional anti-terrorist structure (RATS) is a permanent body under Quad. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 1 is correct. Unlike the SCO, BRICS and even NATO, the Quad does not have a secretariat. RATS is a permanent body of the Sandhi Cooperation Organization (SCO). Source. 14. Carbon Border Adjustment Mechanism (CBAM) is the initiative of a OECD. B. United States. C. European Union (EU). D. BRICS. Solution. C. 42. Recently, the European Union (EU) has put forward a proposal called the Carbon Border Adjustment Mechanism (CBAM). The US, Canada and Japan are planning similar measures. This involves imposing tariffs on imports from other countries that are seen to be using carbon-intensive methods of production. It is argued that the stringent environmental regulation in the EU makes the production of polluting industries move to countries with relatively lax regulation. Source. 15. The Nehru-Yalta Pact, also known as the Delhi Pact, was a bilateral agreement signed between India and Pakistan in order to provide a framework for. A. River water sharing. B. Posting security forces at the border. C. Exploration of mineral resources. D. Treatment of minorities in the two countries. Solution. D. The Nehru-Yalta Pact, also known as the Delhi Pact, was a bilateral agreement signed between India and Pakistan in order to provide a framework for the treatment of minorities in the two countries. It was signed by the two countries' prime ministers, Jawaharlal Nehru and Liaquat Ali Khan. The need for such a pact was felt by minorities in both countries following partition, which was accompanied by massive communal rioting. Source. 16. Consider the following statements regarding critical minerals partnership. 1. It has been established to accelerate the development of diverse and sustainable critical energy mineral supply chains globally. 2. It has been led by United States. 3. India has become the newest partner. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. C. Critical Minerals Partnership. India has become the newest partner of the US-led Mineral Security Partnership, MSP, that has been established to accelerate the development of diverse and sustainable critical energy. Mineral supply chains globally. The MSP, which started in June 2022, has 12 other partner countries, plus the European Union. India's Epsilon Carbon Limited will invest $650 million in a greenfield electric vehicle battery component factory, which will be the largest ever Indian investment in the US electric vehicle battery industry. Source. 17. Consider the following statements regarding International Criminal Court, ICC. 1. International Criminal Court, ICC, is the first permanent, treaty-based, international criminal court established to help end impunity for the perpetrators of the most serious crimes of concern to the international community. 2. The ICC has universal territorial jurisdiction to investigate and prosecute crimes of international concern. 3. India is a member of the court. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 143. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. A. Only statement 1 is correct. The International Criminal Court, ICC, located in The Hague, is the court of last resort for prosecution of genocide, war crimes, and crimes against humanity. It is the first permanent, treaty-based, international criminal court established to help end impunity for the perpetrators of the most serious crimes of concern to the international community. Its founding treaty, the Rome Statute, entered into force on July 1, 2002. Funding. All the court's expenses are funded primarily by state parties. It also receives voluntary contributions from governments, international organizations, individuals, corporations, and other entities. Composition and voting power. The court's management oversight and legislative body, the Assembly of State Parties, consists of one representative from each state party. Each state party has one vote and every effort has to be made to reach decisions by consensus. If consensus cannot be reached, decisions are made by vote. The Assembly is presided over by President and two Vice Presidents, who are elected by the members to 3-year terms. The ICC lacks universal territorial jurisdiction and may only investigate and prosecute crimes committed within member states, crimes committed by nationals of member states, or crimes in situations referred to the court by the United Nations Security Council. The US government has never been a member of the court. Some countries have neither signed nor acceded to the Rome Statute. Some of them, including China and India, are critical of the court. 7. Quality. 1. Consider the following statements regarding Governing Council of Mighty Ayog. 1. The Governing Council embodies the objectives of cooperative federalism and provides a platform to discuss intersectoral, interdepartmental and federal issues. 2. It is headed by the Prime Minister of India. 3. It comprises the chief ministers of all the states and union territories with legislature. 4. The Governing Council meeting is held biannually since the inception of Mighty Ayog. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. Only 3. D. All 4. Solution. C. Statement 4 is incorrect. 44. The Governing Council of Mighty Ayog comprises the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Chief Ministers of all the States and Union Territories by Legislature, Lieutenant Governors of other UTs, Ex-Officio Members, Vice-Chairman, Mighty Ayog, Full-Time Members, Mighty Ayog, and Special Invitees. It is the premier body tasked with evolving a shared vision of national priorities and strategies, with the active involvement of states in shaping the development narrative. The Governing Council, which embodies the objectives of cooperative federalism, presents a platform to discuss intersectoral, interdepartmental and federal issues to accelerate the implementation of the national development agenda. So far, 8 meetings of the Governing Council have been held under the chairmanship of the Honorable Prime Minister. Source. 2. Consider the following statements. 1. The first legislation to govern the management and administration of prisons in India was the Prisons Act of 1894. 2. As per the provisions of the Constitution, prisons and persons detained there fall under the concurrent list. 3. The Modern Prisons Act 2023 makes provisions for the grant of parole, furlough, and remission. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 2 is incorrect. The Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA, announced that it has finalized the preparation of the Modern Prisons Act 2023 to replace the existing 130-year-old colonial law. Intending to provide guidance and address gaps in the existing prison laws, the 2023 Act seeks to bring in the use of technology in prison management, make provisions for the grant of parole, furlough, and remission, and introduce special provisions for women and transgender inmates. The first legislation to govern the management and administration of prisons in India was the Prisons Act of 1894. As per the provisions of the Constitution, prisons and persons detained there fall under the state list. This means that the responsibility of prison management and administration solely rests with the state government, which alone is competent to make appropriate legislative provisions in this regard. Source. 3. Consider the following statements. 1. Protection of electors' identity is integral to free and fair elections and an arbitrary distinction between a voter who casts and a voter who does not cast his vote is violative of Article 14. 2. In India, abstention from voting in general elections is protected as freedom of expression. 3. Systematic voters' education for electoral participation is being implemented by the Union Ministry of Law and Justice. How many of the above statements are correct? A. Only 1. B. Only 2. 45. C. All 3. D. None. Solution. B. Statement 3 is incorrect. The Supreme Court, in PUCLVS Union of India, 2013, popularly known as the Noted Judgment, has held that abstention from voting and negative voting are protected as freedom of expression, a fundamental right. Article 19. The AT has consistently held in practice this by implementing its flagship program called SVEP, Systematic Voters' Education for Electoral Participation, since 2010. In PUCLVS Union of India, the court said, protection of electors' identity and affording secrecy is integral to free and fair elections and an arbitrary distinction between a voter who casts and a voter who does not cast his vote is violative of Article 14. Thus, secrecy is to be maintained for both categories of persons. 4. Consider the